The following is a production of Hometown and Home Country Radio Sports.
We've never seen a team like this before, ladies and gentlemen. After all this time, Bishop Garrigan is still golden. Bishop Garrigan has finally slain the Newell Fonda Dragon. Your Golden Bears are state champions for the second year in a row.
This place is packed, and it is going to be rocking in here tonight. Crooks taps it backwards, and we are underway. Buckle your seatbelts, everyone. In the lane, Crooks, center of the paint. Oh, a nice spin move, and she lays it in.
Oh, with her left hand, she claps her hands and says, let's go. You got to feed Audie this last 2 minutes.
Three-pointer is blocked at the buzzer, and that's it. After coming so close the past 2 years, Bishop Garrigan has finally won it all.
Video streaming on the Algona Radio YouTube channel is brought to you by Kemna Auto Center. Where it's not just about the car, it's about the care. Algona Municipal Utilities, community owned for community benefit. Bauer Plumbing and Heating of Emmitsburg and Algona. Iowa State Bank, helping people succeed. Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident. PMC Advantage Insurance, having the advantage makes all the difference. Now, here's Sports Director Tyler Lance.
The girls' Class 1A postseason rolls on tonight for the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. We've seen part one of the story, and we've seen part two of the story. The past 2 years, state championship wins. And tonight, that title defense continues as the two-time defending state champion Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears host the North Iowa Bison in this Class 1A Region 6 playoff matchup. Good evening, everyone. Tyler Lance with you here on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream. The number 5 ranked team in the state, Bishop Garrigan, comes into the postseason 20-2 overall. They had a first-round bye, and they'll take on North Iowa for the third time this season. Both of the previous matchups went the way of the Golden Bears, 71-41 back on December 19th and 67-42 on February 5th. However, it got a little tougher that second time around. Golden Bears got a test from the Bison before pulling away late in that regular season finale. And tonight, we'll see North Iowa for the second game in a row as the Bison try to spring the road upset and end the hopes of a three-peat. We'll have it all coming up for you tonight on 92.7 KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream as we'll talk with both head coaches, Rick Meyer of the North Iowa Bison and Brandon Schwab of the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. They're coming up next after these messages from the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union.
The Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union encourages positive behavior.
Pride, respect, leadership, and sportsmanship on the court and in the stands.
Remember what a great privilege it is to see your team compete.
Thank you for your attendance. Enjoy the game.
And enjoy the game.
Getting set for girls postseason basketball action here on Hometown Radio KLGA as Bishop Garrigan hosts North Iowa. And right now we're joined by North Iowa head coach Rick Meyer. Coach, first of all, we appreciate your time today on the pregame show. Let's just begin with what the past few days look like for the teams. You guys pick up a first round playoff win against West Hancock, then a couple days off to prepare for this game against Bishop Garrigan. So what have you guys been focusing on the past couple days of practice heading into this matchup?
The biggest thing we've been focusing on is defense and trying to tighten that up a little bit in terms of how we're playing and coverage of different offenses and where we need to be in terms of, you know, whether it be post play or the outside. How do we rotate? How do we get out there to get on the shooters and cover that in terms of, you know, trying to tighten the defense up? We've been playing decent, pretty good defense here for most part of the year, but we are times where we kind of lax off a little bit and don't quite get out quick enough on the shooters. So we've been kind of looking at that and trying to tighten that up here a little bit in the last few days of practice.
Well, coach, as we quickly flash back here to the first round playoff game you guys played, 45-42 win over West Hancock on the road. So what did you feel were a couple of the big deciding factors in that ball game or a couple key turning points for your team?
The deciding factor was probably our defense. We kind of switched things up a little bit against West Hancock. You know, we didn't play the same defense all night. We'd alter a little bit between some different types of defense just to keep them off guard and to make them have to run their offense with what we were going up against. So, you know, the defense was really a key component to our win against West Hancock, particularly that second half. And the other thing was rebounding. We did a real good job of rebounding against West Hancock. I think we had like 22 or 23 offensive rebounds and 25, 26 defensive rebounds. So we limited it there. Second, third chance opportunities, and on the offensive end, we were able to get multiple looks just because we got the offensive rebound, and we were able to get second, third chance points that helped us a lot. So I would say, you know, defense and then the rebounding was a big key to that win.
Well, Coach, you head into another playoff game tonight as you got to travel on the road to face Bishop Garrigan. Obviously, the third time this season you've seen the Golden Bears. When you're facing a team you're this familiar with and facing a team for the third time this season, does that present any unique challenges that might be different than a normal playoff game? And, you know, you kind of had the same situation against West Hancock this past Thursday as well.
You know, I don't think there's any unique changes or anything like that. They're a good team. They've got a good inside post presence and then excellent outside shooters, you know, with a three-point shot. And, of course, Abby Capacious is just one of those players that is all over the floor, and you just got to kind of account for her wherever she's at. So, you know, haven't played them already twice in the regular season. You know, we kind of have an idea of what to expect from them. But, again, tournaments, it's time to kind of tighten some things up, maybe do a little bit of more adjusting on the defensive end, maybe switch a few things up from what we did previously just to maybe throw them off guard for a little bit and see if we can't steal a couple of possessions and, you know, hopefully give them less ideal looks from the field to where they've got to maybe rush a shot or throw up a shot that they're not ready to do and try to, you know, do some things there on that end. But, you know, for the most part, you know, at this time of the year, offensively, you're not going to change much. And defensively, you know, maybe tweaks here or there. But for the most part, you're kind of sticking with what you've been doing and just trying to tighten things up on the defensive end against a team like Garrigan.
Coach, along those same lines, as we wrap up, what do you see as the biggest deciding factor in this game?
I think it's going to be our defense in terms of covering the three-point shooters. You know, we've the times we've played them here earlier this year, we've given up, I think, you know, 10, 11 three-point shots in those contests. And, you know, if we can cut that down to half, you know, and not give up quite as many points from the behind the three-point line and make them earn them from inside that to where, you know, defensively we can, you know, collapse down a bit harder and cover some things there. I think that's going to be a big key, is to limit their opportunities from the three-point line. But also, we've got to take care of the basketball. In the games where we don't turn the ball over, you know, a huge amount, we tend to be a little bit better in terms of offense and defense, and we're a little bit closer in those games. So I would say the turnover side of things, tighten up on the defensive end, and, of course, rebounding is going to be a key.
Well, Coach, we appreciate your time today and wish you best of luck in this matchup.
All right, thank you very much.
That is North Iowa basketball coach Rick Meyer with his pregame thoughts. Right now, we'll step aside for a quick timeout. Come back with more pregame action next on Hometown Radio, KLGA.
The definition of sportsmanship is the quality of showing fairness,
respect and generosity towards the opposing team and officials.
The things you say and do are a direct reflection of your school and community.
Please stay positive and enjoy the game.
And enjoy the game.
Enjoy the game.
We get set for girls postseason basketball action on Hometown Radio KLGA as Bishop Garrigan hosts North Iowa. And right now we're joined by Bishop Garrigan head coach Brandon Schwab. Coach, first of all, we appreciate your time on the pregame show today as we head into the first postseason matchup for the Golden Bears. Talk to me a bit about what the past couple days have looked like once you found out your match was going to be against North Iowa. What those past couple days have looked like as you prepared for the Bison?
Well, like we talked last week, you know, we spent 3 days just on ourselves and some things that we needed to get better at and sharpen up before the tournament run. And, you know, really had 3 good days and not talking about another team, of just working on the things that we needed to improve on. And I thought we've taken some big steps this week off. It was a much needed week for us, I think, and really touched base on some stuff. We had started in on North Iowa, obviously, on Friday and also on Sunday and Monday. So we hit 3 days in North Iowa, but we weren't going to touch on them till we knew who we were going to play. So we didn't. We started in on Friday and start working on game plan and matchups and everything that has to do with preparation for a district game.
Is there anything unique preparation-wise or just in your approach when it comes to facing a team for the third time in a season, especially one that you just saw at the end of the regular season?
I think it's mindset is a lot of, you know, your mindset. You know, it's, you have to get your team, you've got to get focused on a team you're going to be playing a third time, which with the 2 previous times being wins by us, you have to have the right mindset. You know, every single year in districts, an upset happens. And, you know, you've got to have the mindset that you're not going to have it happen to you. And so you've got to prepare for a team you beat twice as much as you'd prepare for a team that you haven't seen all year. So just getting the mindset of, you know, we've got to execute the way we're capable of. We've got to, you know, do the little things right and not just look past, you know, what we beat them by the two previous times, but looking past of making sure that we're hitting the stride at the right time. We're playing our game. And so, you know, a lot of it's just mindset of getting them focused on everyone's undefeated right now. You know, there's no room for error. There's no room for us not playing to our capability. And I think we've got a good mindset coming into tonight.
We're talking right now with Bishop Garrigan head coach Brandon Schwab. And coach, when you talk about mindset, another aspect of that is the fact that, you know, you have a group of players who do have some experience of last year's postseason run, some players who played roles and coming off the bench, going to state and winning the state title last year. But how does the mindset change for those players as they're now in the leading roles this season as compared to last year?
Yeah, you know, them players have got a lot of experience this year with, you know, being in big games, playing good teams, and, you know, postseason is, you know, an extension of your season, but it's a new season. You know, I mean, everything, we earned the right to host two home games. We earned the right of a conference title. We earned the right, you know, to get the number one seed in our region. Those are all earned things and not taken for granted, but those were earned. And a lot of our so-called role players last season have all season stepped into big roles for us, you know, and we're a balanced team that our leading scorer could be a different girl every single night we play. And, you know, and all of our players are ready and in a mindset to be that leading scorer tonight. Whether that happens or not, we've got to be okay in finding that hot hand and making sure that maturity of, you know, finding that hot hand, doing the little things. If your shot isn't going, how are you going to defend that night? How are you impacting the game when it's not you scoring? You know, those are all big things that go into districts, because we won't have five leading scorers tonight. We're going to probably have one leading scorer. Who that is, I don't know. But we've got to be okay with when it's somebody else, when it's not your shot's not going on, how else are you impacting that game? And that's a part of maturity as a basketball player. I mean, everybody wants to score the ball. Everybody wants their shot to go in big moments. And it's what are you going to do when it doesn't go in? And how are you impacting the game? I should be able to see that tonight. I should be able to see you impact the game on the court, not just by scoring, because we're going to score the ball. We have scorers, and just finding that hot hand and that maturity of being able to do that is a big process step up that we need to have tonight.
Coach, as we wrap up the interview, what do you see as one or two of the biggest deciding factors for tonight's game?
You know, I think rebounding is really big. North Iowa is a very good rebounding team, very much improved, you know, down the stretch here. And, you know, they're healthy. They've got their full roster there. The first time we played them, they didn't have arguably their best guard, Beckler, with them. You know, she played very well the last time we played them with 16 or 18 points, and they really kind of were able to get some second chances on us. So we've got to make sure to keep them off of the boards, and we need to make sure to get the game in a fast-paced game and keep them off the boards. Those are two big keys for tonight.
Coach, thank you for the time today, and best of luck in tonight's game.
All right, thanks.
Bishop Garrigan girls basketball coach Brandon Schwab with his pregame thoughts. We'll step aside for a timeout and bring you more next coming up on Hometown Radio KLGA.
Thank you to these postseason sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Purpling Boyd & Company, CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Algona Livestock Auction, sales every Monday.
American Glass, for all your glass needs, think American.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, with two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, check their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Postseason sports club members bringing you this game.
Is your student athlete on the injured list? This is Shane Meschke, one of the physical therapists at Kossuth Regional Health Center. Our medical team is ready to help get your athlete back in the game. KRHC offers concussion testing, therapy and rehab services, family medicine, 24-hour emergency care, x-ray services, and more. Our staff works closely with local health care providers and specialists throughout the area for a recovery plan that works for you. Best of luck to all our area athletes this season. We'll be cheering for you.
We've got more postseason sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Erpelding Excavating, they dig dirt.
Bill's Auto and Truck Repair, getting you back on the road.
All sponsors of this postseason broadcast.
A big bank can deliver the products you need and the convenience you expect. A small bank can make you feel like family. At Fidelity Bank and Trust, we don't think you should have to choose. Your hometown bankers have roots here. We understand the community and why you want to live here, because we live here too. We're big enough to deliver, yet small enough to care. Fidelity Bank and Trust, your hometown bank. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Your hometown Fidelity Bank and Trust, located in Bancroft, Iowa.
It's time to meet the starting lineup for the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears.
Zoe Montag, junior, number 22.
Garrigan at the steal. Here comes the transition. A sidestep by Montag in the lay-in. Zoe Montag is going crazy right now, and Garrigan's up 81-38.
Emmy Bartolo, sophomore, number 10.
Cross-court feed over to Bartolo. Catches, fires, rattles in a three-pointer.
Tayshia Aulish, sophomore, number 24.
Tayshia hangs and passes to the left wing. Aulish free try, and she swished it again. Let Tayshia Aulish shoot it.
Gracelyn Eastman, freshman, number 15.
Kicks it out Eastman. Eastman a tray. Eastman knocks it down. First career three-pointer.
Abby Capacious, senior, number 21.
Capacious weaves around traffic, puts it up. She put it in the foul. Abby Capacious with a chance for a three-point play. Tip-off of your game is coming up next on Hometown and Home Country Radio. That is the starting lineup for the back-to-back defending state champion Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears under head coach Brandon Schwab. For the North Iowa Bison and head coach Rick Meyer, it'll be the junior Aisha Jobe, the freshman Bella Langfald, junior Ashlyn Beekler, senior Becca Hoffman, and senior Miriam Binkin. For Bishop Garrigan, the white home uniforms, the black BGHS across the front, black numerals on the front and back outlined in yellow. For the North Iowa Bison, they have the black road uniforms, the white North Iowa on the front and back with the white numerals, and the blue trim around the side of the jersey. North Iowa coming in 8-14 on the season. They finished 8th place in the top of Iowa West this year, 4-13 in conference games. Bishop Garrigan 20-2, 15-1 in the conference, including 2 wins at North Iowa. At midcourt, it's Abby Capacious for Bishop Garrigan to jump it up. She'll go up against Miriam Binkin for North Iowa. Binkin checking in at 6 feet, Capacious at 5'7", as we're just about set to go. Postseason action beginning for the back-to-back defending state champion Golden Bears, trying to win that third title in a row, and it all begins tonight against North Iowa. Binkin and Capacious at midcourt. Ball's in the air. Binkin wins the tap, and we are underway from Bishop Garrigan High School as North Iowa heads right to left on the radio dial. North Iowa has the ball up top to Beekler. Now high post to Binkin, looking down low. A nice catch underneath by Langfald, and she draws a quick foul. North Iowa getting that ball inside early on that first possession.
Abby Capacious had her hand on the ball, but it slid off the ball and onto the forearm and picks up her first foul. Capacious is focused and ready to go. Her senior year, she's the only senior starter for the Bears. And, boy, she is ready to roll for this post-tournament. Talk about a focused athlete. Saw her in the hallways today. She was ready to go as the first free throw is missed.
First free throw rims out. No score here on Hometown Radio, KLGA Algona. Winner tonight plays on Friday night against either Newman Catholic or St. Ansgar as the second free throw will go down, and North Iowa grabs the 1-0 lead on the road. Bishop Garrigan brings their offense out, averaging 63.5 points per game. Number one in the top of Iowa West this year as Bartolo heads left around the perimeter, finding Montag in the corner. 7:40 on the clock. Now Bartolo deep in the left wing. Back to Montag, left corner. Looking inside, Eastman passes out of her range and tracks down by Beekler for North Iowa.
Montag's been throwing that lob pass very successfully all year.
Beekler pulling up for a tray, left it short. Rebound by Binkin in the lane. Binkin looking to go underneath to Langfald, knocked away, but it goes back out to Binkin. Kicks it out, Beekler, right wing three, and she missed it right. Ball deflects, fourth opportunity for North Iowa. Shot off the glass, no good for Hoffman, and a jump ball on the rebound as Garrigan has the possession arrow.
Yeah, Binkin took a shot in her right eye. She's holding her right eye as she goes down the floor. She's the one that just did the tip for North Iowa. She's the tallest person on the floor, 6 foot tall. Her and Capacious shook hands, had a good laugh before the game started. But it's all business now. Binkin, a tough force down there inside.
And North Iowa unable to capitalize on the second chance opportunities, but rebounding going to be a major factor tonight as Montag has it left wing, looking to kind of get patient, deflects off her hands. It finds Eastman on the block, powers it up, it rolls off, no good. And the rebound by Binken for North Iowa. Binken averaging 9.5 rebounds per game for the Bison this year. North Iowa had 22 offensive rebounds against West Hancock as Binken shoots with her foot on the top of the arc on the three-point line. That jumper is no good. Montag and Binken scrapping for the rebound, and Binken forced the tie-up.
Boy, Montag did a great job elevating, securing that rebound. But when she turned around to make the Atlas pass, she found Binken right in her face, and Binken causes her second jump ball in the first 2 minutes of this game.
Beekler from the left side baseline, whips it into Jobe on the wing. 6:44 on the clock, quarter number one. Now it's Hoffman. Hoffman works the dribble. Two dribbles and gets it right to Jobe. Jobe into the right corner to Beekler. Eyed the bucket, she'll drive instead. Jobe gets pivoted around 360 as Capacious stays in front. Bounce pass in the lane, Binken. Shot blocked on the way up. Eastman has it for Garrigan. Now here comes Bartolo across half court up the near side. Bartolo drifting away from Binken, lobbing it across towards Olish in front of the Garrigan student section, down to our left. Pass underneath to Eastman, makes a tough catch, puts it off the glass and draws the foul. Two free throws coming for Gracelyn Eastman.
Well, three possessions, three times they have got the ball inside to Eastman. That time she draws the foul, will go to the free throw line. But she smacks her hands and she's frustrated. She didn't get the and one there. She thought she had the ability to put that bucket through whilst getting fouled.
Gracelyn Eastman swishes the first foul shot. She's 65.4% from the line this year, and she ties the game at one apiece. Eastman had a good game last time these two teams matched up. 16 points and 7 rebounds at the end of the regular season as Eastman knocks down the free throw, and Garrigan has their first lead at 2-1. Beekler up the near side. Garrigan looked like they were going to trap her, but instead they'll let her get the ball away to Binken. Binken between the circles, lobbing it right wing to Jobe. Jobe looking inside. She bounces it into the high post to Binken, looking underneath to Langfald. It's off her hands, out of bounds, and Garrigan touched it last as it will save the Bison with 6:05 on the clock.
Good defense by the Bears. They are anticipating the pass. They've seen the offense. They know where the ball's going to go. They try to jump that pass.
Bison trying to work that high-low look early in the game. It's entry pass to Langfald, knocked away, and here come the Bears. It's Bartolo running the floor, finds Olish, pulls from the wing, and it's a little bit too strong. But Capacious rebounds on the near side and brings it back out. Pulls it into Eastman, on the block, takes a dribble, turnaround jumper, no good, and rebound tracked down by North Iowa's. Langfald has it, and Langfald fouled in transition.
Well, Sasha Olish has a look on her face that it's on her, and it is.
That'll be the first foul by Olish, second foul by Bishop Garrigan here in quarter number one. North Iowa beat West Hancock 45-42 on Thursday night. They did not have a great shooting night, only shooting 28% and only making one of 17 three-pointers, but those 22 offensive rebounds were the deciding factor and over 40 total rebounds for North Iowa in that game. In the right corner, Beekler fires it across, intercepted by Bartolo at the foul line. 5:31 on the clock, Bartolo across half court, trying to jumpstart the Garrigan offense. Montag on the right wing. Looking back across towards Olish left wing to the high post to Capacious. Pass underneath to Eastman, tipped away. It rolls towards the corner and it's picked up by Hoffman for North Iowa. Eastman trying to steal it back. She knocks it out of bounds as Eastman touched it last.
Well, just like the previous time these two teams met, this play pace has been very spirited, very physical, very fast-paced. That was the case the last time these two teams met up, so I don't know why I'd expect anything different.
Hoffman, one step inside of half court. She weaves in between three right jerseys, bounces it right side to Jobe. Jobe catches and releases the three. It's an air ball to clean it by Binken, and she spun it in. 3-2 North Iowa.
Boy, she didn't just spin that in. That thing hung on the rim and was doing a turntable spinaroo before it dropped through the net.
Binken averaging just under 10 points per game this season for the Bison. Their second leading scorer behind Beekler as Bartolo enters the lane. Kicks to Montag. Catch and shoot three off the back of the cup. Rebound by Olish on the near side, and she'll bring it back out to the right wing. Guarded by Jobe. Olish, she'll head left and bounce it to Bartolo. Bartolo from the left wing. Head fakes. Drives in. Ball stripped away. Binken has it for North Iowa. 3-2 Bison. Binken can run the floor. She bounces it right. Layup up, and it pops into the cup. That is Hoffman finishing it, and it's 5-2 Bison.
Good transition secondary break basketball for the Bison there. Bears reset. Bartolo on the wing.
Golden Bears having a little trouble getting the ball inside early in this ball game as Olish crosses over. She heads left to the paint. She'll slice in. Shot rejected by Binken. She knocked it off its arc, and it's out of bounds as Bishop Garrigan will keep it.
Well, that's a height advantage for Binken down there for North Iowa. She swats that away, and a boy, Tyler, a good block always gets the crowd fired up. People love blocks.
It does, and North Iowa coming out with some big-time energy on the road in this tough, tough matchup against the number 5-ranked Golden Bears, who have won 20 games this season after graduating Audie Crooks and Molly Joyce. Pass inside to Eastman, she'll head right. Eastman fires it up, no good. Capacious offensive board, put back, no, but a foul. Two free throws for Capacious, who stays active on the glass.
Well, third board for Capacious now in the game with 4 minutes left in the first quarter. Not surprising, Tyler, we've said it all year. Abby Capacious, one of the best rebounders in the area, in the state probably. She's tough in the glass. She came in from outside. There were a couple bison there just waiting for the ball, but Abby swooped in and surprised them and snatched it.
Well, Abby Capacious had a good game last time these two teams matched up. A very Capacious-like stat line. 4 points, 15 rebounds, and 6 assists as Capacious tees up the first foul shot and missed it off to the left.
You know, it is interesting to look at Capacious' career. Leading three-point shooter as a sophomore, and then with Audie and Molly on the team, everyone thought, well, when they graduate, then Abby's going to be the scorer. But she knows her role. She'll do whatever she needs to do to make the team win. And it's definitely not always scoring because they got shooters galore and Eastman. So Abby Capacious is a great facilitator.
Second free throw down the chute. It's 5-3 North Iowa as Coach Schwab will use a 30-second timeout for Bishop Garrigan. We're almost halfway through the first quarter, Beanie, and Bishop Garrigan still has yet to hit a field goal. Bison, they're making things tough defensively, even though the Bison haven't gotten it going offensively either.
Yeah, they're doing a great job defensively against the Bears, really making the Bears utilize their offense, and the Bears are responding. They're working the ball around. They're moving the ball around the perimeter, and they are clearly determined to get the ball inside to Eastman down low. They've done it a few times, but the Bison defense has collapsed, made it tough for her to finish the shots. They're not going to stray from that, but the Bears, they will break a run when this tempo gets going. A couple steals. Bartola has 2 steals already. One of these steals will lead to a layup, and then the scoring will open up.
You touched on the big factor, turnovers. The Bison had 24 turnovers against West Hancock, still one on Thursday, and they averaged 23.5 turnovers per game this year, as though turned it over right on cue, trying to fire it down to the block to Langfold as it's off her hands.
Well, Tyler, that was a great prediction. You called for the turnover, and then they turned the ball over. So why don't you call for a three-pointer here?
Well, Garrigan shot the free ball really well against North Iowa with 11 three-point makes in that final regular season game. As Olish has it left wing, a good three-point shooter for Garrigan finds Eastman in the high post. Bullet to Montag, right corner three, rims out, no good. Eastman cleanup, Eastman put back in.
That'll get the Bears started. There's a great drive and kick out to an open Montag in the corner. That's what Bartolo and Olish do with those drives.
Tied up at 5 apiece, and Job travels on the backcourt. She tried to spin on that pivot foot, but took a little hop at the end of that, and North Iowa suffers their second turnover in a row.
Well, if I had a pen and paper, I should probably keep track of the amount of turnovers in this game. As after half of this first quarter under wraps, clearly that's going to be a factor here in this game.
5-5 tie, Bishop Garrigan and North Iowa at the 3:28 mark of quarter number one. Bounce pass right corner to Capacious. Works the baseline to try to force her down. She finds Eastman in the center of the paint. Eastman draws the foul. She put it in. Gracelyn Eastman of great balance and a chance for a three-point play.
What an assist by Capacious. Capacious drives with no intent to score. She just draws the defense, leaves Eastman wide open, and Eastman's got to give Capacious a high five for that look.
Free throw goes down. 8-5, Bishop Garrigan. As Eastman has 7 out of those 8 points. Capacious with the other point for Garrigan. North Iowa gets it across half court to Brooklyn Price, the freshman who just checked in. Now they get it down underneath, trying to create space. Eichenberger, and she traveled.
Oh, third consecutive turnover for the Bison. Bears are going to come back, and why go away from Eastman? It's working well. You know, last play down, Eastman kind of initiated that contact. Like, she's really, that's not a freshman move. She really, really doesn't play like a freshman inside.
And now travel by Stacia Olish. Her jaw's on the floor right now. She shakes her head, and Garrigan gives the turnover back to North Iowa.
She got so excited about that entry pass that she forgot what her feet were up to.
North Iowa basketball. Garrigan shows some pressure in the backcourt. As Beekler is trapped along the sideline, she'll throw a long pass to Job. It's over her head and into the Garrigan bench.
So Beekler for North Iowa is saying, hey, you got to be open on the other side of that mid-court line for me to throw the ball to you, to her teammate. But she dribbled right into the trap at mid-court. You got to stay out of that trap if you're Beekler.
Bounce pass right corner to Capacious. Capacious works the baseline, got it inside to Eastman again, and Eastman finishes again. An identical play to last time, Beanie, minus the foul.
Yeah, why change the play call if they can't stop it?
Job into the paint. Job trying to stop. She'll rise for a 14-foot jumper, pops out of the cup. Went everywhere but down as Eastman grabs the rebound. Here comes Capacious striding across half court. Gives it off to Olish. Passes up the three. She'll drive instead. Wraps the pass around to Bartolo. Bartolo catch and shoot. Outside the corner, no good. It's an air ball. Capacious rebound, and Capacious puts it back for two.
There is classic Abby Capacious. She did not get that rebound with anything other than her brain. She just knew right where that air ball was going to go, and she got to the spot.
A 10-0 run going on right now by Bishop Garrigan as North Iowa head coach Rick Meyer calls a 30-second timeout. Well, the rebounding, as we said, a big factor in tonight's game, and North Iowa had that one possession when they got 4 opportunities. Since then, though, it's been Garrigan getting those second-chance opportunities. Capacious always in position. Eastman as well. They're really leading the way in rebounding tonight.
Yeah, and the rebounds have been turning into instant offense. That's what we just called there in that last 30-second timeout. The Bears, they score in spurts. They go on streaks where they shoot a couple threes, they get a couple steals for layups, and the lead balloons real quick. So there's never really any panic in this team when it's a couple point margin, because they always know the next big run is right around the corner.
12-5, Bishop Garrigan, 2:21 left in the first quarter as Buechler has it in the backcourt, wings it up ahead to Price, far side. Guarded by Eastman on the perimeter, gets it to the foul line. Jumper on the way, banks in. Eichenberger breaks up the 10-0 run. Back the other way comes Garrigan quickly. Capacious gives it right towards Bartolo. Takes one dribble towards the left and lobs it over to Montag in the corner. She'll fake to the right to Bartolo. Finds Capacious baseline. She gets inside. Shot up the side of the rim. No good. Eastman is there. Eastman put back. No good. Ball's loose on the floor. Eichenberger trying to pick it up. It rolls towards the baseline, and that's out of bounds. North Iowa touched it last. They could never secure that bouncing ball along the baseline.
Yeah, that was just pinball down there. Off Eastman's feet, off a couple Bison's feet, into hands, out of hands, and finally a turnover. You're just waiting for that ball to go out of bounds for a solid call.
Allish lobbing to Eastman. Center of the lane. Eastman powers it up. Off glass and scores.
Boy, Eastman has got it going. She's got a lot of energy. She's popping up off the floor.
11 points by Eastman, who came in averaging 16.3 for the Bears. Price gets it in between the circles to Buechler. Buechler works the dribble, goes left to Jobe on the wing. Right back to Buechler at the top of the arc. 1:35 left in the first quarter. Price right side now for North Iowa off the Buechler pass. Finds Jobe right corner. Jobe back out to Price, trying to shake loose from Bartolo. Gets to the foul line, she'll find Eichenberger. Takes on dribble and picks it up. Comes left side to Jobe. Long two by Jobe, little bit short, and Eastman secures the rebound. And her pass gets knocked away in the backcourt. North Iowa has it. They try to get underneath to Langfold. Throws it off Capacious. It goes right to Eichenberger. And there's two.
Oh, what a series. Another pinball situation. Bounced right off Capacious' chest into Eichenberger's hands.
Yeah, fortuitous bounce for North Iowa, who scored the last 4 points now as Eastman pivots, finds Capacious underneath. A great find and a great score.
Oh, one of the better assists I've seen Eastman do all year. She always is looking for that hoop. That time she found a teammate for an easy bucket.
Capacious turned invisible along the baseline that time. She was unknown to the North Iowa defense. Pass inside, intercepted by Eastman. Out to Bartolo, trying to run it down. She'll pick it up. Jobe flies by. Bartolo layup up and in. What an athletic play by Bartolo to save that pass.
Oh, she is an athlete. Emmy Bartolo is soft. We got Alyssa Holguin in the game, so three sophomore guards in the game, along with Eastman, the freshman, and the senior Capacious. It's a young team for Bishop Garrigan here with the success.
And Garrigan will foul in the backcourt again. That will be foul number three, and it will go against Emmy Bartolo, her first personal.
Boy, they've really picked up their defense. They're in a 2-3, but you can hardly tell it's a 2-3 because as soon as that ball crosses half court, everybody is trying to swarm to that ball in the passing lane.
18-9, Bishop Garrigan here in quarter number one. Final 25 seconds as the shot clock is off for North Iowa. Eastman knocks the pass away from the high post, and Price saves it right before half court. Gets it across to Buechler. Buechler drives baseline. Buechler floats it over Capacious. Off the front of the cup, no good, and Capacious secures the rebound. Gets it out to Hoagland with 12 seconds, with 11 seconds. Left to Allish. Allish, catch and release on the three. A little bit too strong. Long rebound with 6 seconds out to Price. Price with 4 seconds back to the center of the court. Price, long pass up ahead to Buechler. Buechler had it knocked away, and that is the end of the first quarter. Bishop Garrigan with a big push. They lead 18-9 heading to the second on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine postseason sports club members.
Dump It. They do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Greg Petting and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Neil Albert Electric. Flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Kemco Tires, your Goodyear tire dealer.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country. Highway 18, just west of Algona.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Postseason Sports Club members bringing you this game.
When it comes to new appliances, you read the reviews and analyze the reports. But many times, you just end up being more confused. That's why customers buy from North Iowa Appliance Center. They're local and they give back to the community. They carry top-performing Maytag appliances designed, engineered, and assembled right here in the United States. With over 45 years of experience, they give prompt and professional service every time. Things are coming in weekly, so stop by today and see what they have in stock. North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest. Carrying Maytag, KitchenAid, Whirlpool, and Amana.
It
is electric tonight inside the Bishop Garrigan High School Gymnasium, and the Golden Bears are starting to feel themselves as they head to the second quarter, up 18-9 over the North Iowa Bison. North Iowa had the early lead in this ballgame, but Bishop Garrigan used a 10-0 run in the middle of that quarter to take control and get up by 9 here as we enter the second. On the right side, it's Aulish. Aulish will drive in. She'll get the pass out to Capacious. Rotates it around to Bartolo. Bartolo driving in, dumps it underneath to Eastman. Eastman took some contact, and she'll be shooting two.
Beekler missed the foul there. She just thought, not going to let Graceland have it this easy. I'm just going to hack her, and gets her right on the arm. Actually, a good job fouling. You don't want to give up the and one situation there. She made sure Eastman wasn't going to make the shot.
And the free throw is good for Graceland Eastman. Well, Beanie, one of the biggest weapons you can give Coach Schwab is a week plus of practice time. This Golden Bear offense, it is really flowing right now. The passing is on point as the second free throw is no good, and the miss is tracked down by North Iowa and Hoffman, but Garrigan steals it away. Layup up and in for Zoe Montag, and it's 21-9.
Well, the Garrigan press has not always created a lot of turnovers against every team, but they have forced multiple turnovers here against the Bison.
Job almost shuffled the shoes that time. Bullets underneath to Langfall with a great find, and Langfall draws the foul. That was a threading of the needle by Job, firing that all the way through the paint and finding the uncontested Langfall there, who ended up taking the contact and ends up shooting two.
Yeah, foul there on Zoe Montag, who hustled back to get in position between the offensive player and the basket and said, nuh-uh, you're not going to get an easy shot like this. Commits the foul and prevented the two-point, and the free throw shot is missed. So that's a positive on that foul by Montag. The Bears just have everything going for them. Even the fouls are clicking.
Langfall, second free throw swishes, and that'll make it 21-10 as Bishop Garrigan leads North Iowa here in the second quarter. Bartolo to engineer the offense, lobs it over to Aulish on the left side. Aulish dribbles right around the perimeter, sidearms the pass, near side to Capacious in front of the Bison bench. Now it's Aulish. Aulish across the foul line, gets it out to Bartolo. Bartolo lets it fly for three, it's off the heel, ball deflects, and Binken has it along the baseline for North Iowa. Binken, long pass over the court, looking for Beekler, and it's over her head as Beekler couldn't quite save that one.
Another turnover for the Bison. This is just crushing their offense here. They can't get that ball up the floor, much less scored if they can't do that. Boy, Tyler, am I wrong? Have the Bears made a three-pointer yet? I don't think so.
No threes yet, as Aulish will try one right on cue, and that is too strong as it clangs off the glass. Beekler grabs the rebound.
They got this team of sharp shooters from the outside, but no threes tonight, and they're missing badly.
15-footer on the other end. Binken, and she'll bank that one in. Make it 21-12 as North Iowa has scored three in a row.
You know, when you're missing badly like that, sometimes it's just players are just almost a little hyper-focused. Just got to relax, let it flow, let the ball rip, and it'll go through.
Yeah, Garrigan had gone 11-31 last time they saw North Iowa. There's a lob to Eastman, edge of the paint, right side. Eastman turns it back outside to Bartolo. Extra pass to Aulish. Her three-point try is good.
There we go.
There's the three, Beanie.
A little more rhythm three, a little more relaxed. The other threes were looking like not their normal shots, but Aulish looked normal on that one.
Aulish scored 21 points, made 6 of 10 threes. Last time these teams matched up, as Garrigan steals the pass again. It rolls away, though, from Montag and goes out of bounds as North Iowa gets it back. This is the Bison team. They are so, so aggressive with how, A, they play defense, and B, how they try to get the ball down the floor. But that aggressiveness can result in fouls and can result in turnovers, as we've seen those turnovers start to stack up.
Yeah, that's one impressive part of this Bison team. They play hard. They go for it. Fun team to watch, just outmatched here.
Hoffman weaves between two right jerseys, gets it up to Beekler. A leading score for North Iowa driving in. Beekler from the baseline, knocks down the jumper and drew the foul. Beekler with a chance for a three-point play.
You bet, and there's no celebration there. She just goes about her business, says, this is what I do. She goes to the free throw line, chance to complete a three-point play. So with Beekler and Benkin, a couple solid players there for the Bison. Benkin, of course, when she was sitting out in the first quarter, that's when Garrigan made their big run, because they just kept going into Eastman, because without Binken, no one to stop Eastman inside.
And the number one free throw shooter on North Iowa at 65% puts that one down the drain and makes it 24-15. Aulish to Bartolo, just to the right of center, now back to Aulish. Fought about three, she'll work it to the elbow instead. Lob inside, tipped away. Here's Binken with the basketball for North Iowa. And Bartolo had a knockaway. Binken got tripped, though, and a foul against Garrigan, their third of the quarter.
Bartolo puts her hands up, says, I swatted at her, but I didn't hit anything. And Binken just tripped. But once the whistle blows, Tyler, it's a whistle, and there's going to be a foul called.
And that'll be Bartolo's second. As three fouls by Garrigan this quarter, one by North Iowa. Price getting it onto the elbow towards Binken, drops the ball and picks it back up, flips it near side to a three-point attempt by Hoffman, and she finds the bottom of the net.
Oh, Hoffman did the old body language. She twisted her back to yank that ball back and knock it through.
North Iowa's on a little run right now. They're getting back into this one. The pass inside to Eastman. Great catch inside. Layup too strong, though. And Binken rips the rebound away. Binken can run the floor. She brings it up ahead for North Iowa with 5:20 on the clock. Bartolo trying to seal it away, but Binken keeps that ball and rips it away from Bartolo.
Well, you saw that rebound by Binken. If Binken's on the bench, Eastman gets her own rebound and puts that back up for two. It's just all about those matchups. They got to have Binken in there if they're going to stop Eastman.
Binken working towards the right side, blocked by Eastman, but a foul. Two more free throws for North Iowa, who's starting to find a way to get to the stripe in this second quarter. North Iowa, when they played West Hancock on Thursday night, attempted 26 free throws, making 14 of those. That was the other big factor in that game, wearing a path to the foul line against the Eagles.
Well, that'll be the second foul on Capacious there. Picks it up in the lane on Binkman's shot attempt. And she shrugs it off, but Reagan Murphy is going to come in and make sure Capacious doesn't pick up a quick third.
And that's foul number four against Bishop Garrigan. So if you're North Iowa, you are really trying to get in the bonus here and see if you can cut even more into this lead by shooting free throws down the stretch in this half.
Absolutely. The question is, who is their player that is going to drive hard in the lane, create contact, and pick up good foul calls? I'm not sure. Probably Binken, Buechler maybe.
Yeah, it's a fundamental question for North Iowa as there's 4:58 left in the second quarter. 24-19, Bishop Garrigan. Murphy into Eastman, takes a power dribble, faces the bucket, and she draws the foul. On the other end, Gracelyn Eastman will shoot two.
And I think they're going to have that on Binken, and that's going to hurt the Bison. She didn't have to foul there. She was just a help person. She's not guarding Eastman contact to contact. She's just a help person. And she's got her third foul, Tyler.
And that is big for North Iowa. How do you manage the rest of the half of her on the bench? She is checking out right now, and Langfald is checking back in.
Oh, that is tough for the Bison. She's going to have to sit the rest of the half, and you know what Coach Schwab and the Bears are going to do with her on the bench.
Eastman free throw miss. Murphy almost had the rebound, but the Bison will secure it instead with Eichenberger. Gives off to Hoffman, who will bring it across the timeline. Basket is towards our left. Pass to the high post. Knocked away by Eastman. The impact felt right away. Now up to Bartolo. Stripped, but a foul. Well, the fouls are picking up. That's number three against North Iowa. And Bartolo's going to be shooting two for Garrigan.
Yeah, there's 4:40 left in the half, but get comfortable because this is going to be a long second quarter with all these fouls. We're going to be shooting a lot of free throws. Have a lot of times to just chat, Tyler. But, boy, I'll say something. Bartolo is fast, and the Bison were able to get back on defense. That's some speed on the Bison team.
Bartolo knocks down the foul shot, and it's 25-19, Bishop Garrigan. Golden Bears were able to make 12 out of 13 free throws in the final regular season game against North Iowa during that 67-42 victory. As Buechler checks back in, Hoffman goes to the bench. 4:40 left here in the first half as winner in this game plays either Newman Catholic or St. Ansgar. Top of Iowa East opponent as the free throw is good for Bartolo. And Coach Schwab wants a 60-second timeout. We'll take that 60 as well right here on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Elgorda Radio YouTube channel.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine postseason sports club members.
Style Salon, your salon in Elgona. Create yourself.
Holmes Animal Clinic, caring for your pets big and small. They love them all.
Daylight Donuts, open early, serving freshly made donuts, rolls, and coffee.
Take Wellness Center, Algona, and Armstrong, keeping athletes in the game.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm insurance agent.
The Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service. Call 295-SOFT.
All sponsors of this postseason game broadcast.
At Wiffles Hybrids, they're completely focused on developing and producing the very best seed corn on the planet. It's an act they've been polishing for more than 70 years, right here in the heart of the Corn Belt. Wiffles Hybrid, one thing done right. For more information, contact Rich Rosenmeyer, Dale Lappy, or Mitchell Carroll at JDR Seed of Wesley, 515-341-2452, or visit wiffles.com.
North Iowa trying to survive the final 4:40 of the first half with Miriam Binken on the bench as she's picked up her third personal foul. North Iowa will face the full court press of Bishop Garrigan as they get it into Price. The freshman picks up her dribble. She lobs it near side to Job. The North Iowa senior brings it across half court. She spins towards the left and gets away from Hoagland. Job looks towards Binken in between the circles. Binken heads right around a screen by Price. Binken make that Buechler towards the baseline. Bounce pass towards Job. Job jumper from the block, and she swishes it.
Job the junior, Binken the senior. But other than that, North Iowa's a pretty young team as well, just like the Bears.
Eastman in the post. Eastman, bull to Murphy, off her hands, though, and out of bounds. 26-21 in favor of Garrigan.
Now Murphy will turn around and defend the inbounds pass. She's tough to inbounds the ball because she's athletic. She jumps, and Buechler is going to try to get it in and does so.
She finds Jobe. Jobe crosses over, tries to squeeze past Bartolo, picks up a dribble in the backcourt, and did she shuffle her shoes again? She did. She's trying to take a hard stomp, but it's just hard to stop on a dime like that as Capacious and Montag return for Garrigan. Hoagland and Murphy go to the bench.
Oh, so you see Coach Schwab, he's setting it up here. Binken is on the bench. He's got Eastman inside. Capacious is the facilitator that can find Graceland Eastman inside. So their offense is going to look for that inside game right now.
The connection between those two so far tonight has been unreal for Garrigan. Bounce pass towards Montag, and now into the right corner towards Capacious. Back up top to Aulish. Whips it into the corner to Bartolo, looking underneath to Eastman. Eastman takes a hard dribble, puts it up, and draws the foul again. That is number four against North Iowa, and Garrigan really wearing a path to the charity stripe here in the past couple minutes of this second quarter.
Yeah, gotta be a lot of free throws. Eastman shooting 60-some percent on the free throw line this year, but I would say her percentage second half of the season is far better than the first half of the season. Yeah, she misses that first one, but she looks like she has really worked on that shot throughout the season at practice and much more confidence in her free throws.
Eastman will try to split the pair here after missing the first one. Bishop Garrigan leading by five as Eastman misses that right. Capacious trying to keep it alive, but it goes towards the baseline where it's picked up by Buechler for North Iowa. Here's Jobe up the near side of the court. Jobe slowly dribbling towards the right, picks it up, pivots, and bounces it towards Buechler. Buechler brings the ball back towards the middle of the court and passes left to Price. Price looking back to Buechler in between the circles. 20 on the shot clock for North Iowa. Right side to Jobe, now back to Buechler. Leading scorer for North Iowa is Buechler. She had 18 last time these two teams matched up. Pass left to Price, and it's over her head as Jobe's throw was a little bit too tall.
Another turnover there. 3:25 left to go until halftime. Capacious back in there playing with two fouls. She would have got that last rebound if she didn't have two fouls and not wanting to pick up a third. So that will calm her down a little bit as she tries not to pick up fouls. And Tyler, I can see foul trouble becoming an issue here in the second half.
Yeah, it certainly could, as the fouls have been big for North Iowa here in the first couple of quarters. As pass goes to Montag, quickly to Bartolo, looking to Eastman high post. Eastman back out to the right wing towards Aulish. Aulish dribbling into the paint, gets the pass over to Bartolo left side, now corner to Montag. North Iowa doing a nice job shutting up the three, and Montag throws it right to Price. Here comes Price on the floor, finding Jobe. Jobe will get by Capacious, she'll stop, but she'll put it up and in. Capacious backed off and let her have that, and then Jobe almost traveled again.
Both these teams get a lot of defense to offense situations.
Montag slicing in, Montag goes glass, and the ball pops out of the cup. Eastman able to reach in there and force a tie-up with 2:45 left in the second, as North Iowa has the possession arrow.
Oh, it was a good grab by Eastman there. Looked like it was all easily the Bison rebound, but the rebounder spun around and presented the ball to Graceland Eastman, who put her meat hooks on there and said, I'll take some of that.
Yes, this Garrigan team is so opportunistic. You've really got to take that rebound and then just get out of there, because Garrigan is always looking to force that tie-up. As Aulish collects the basketball for Garrigan, Golden Bears able to take it away from the Bison and force another turnover. Inside to Eastman, a nice knockaway though by the Bison as Langfall got a handle on it, and almost a foul in the backcourt as getting away from all that was Hoffman.
Oh, the North Iowa crowd wanted a foul called on Eastman, who was leaning and running over.
Oh, Hoffman bounce pass off the leg of Aulish. It rolls over the Langfall. The Langfall has the two. This is a one-point game, ladies and gents. The Bison are charging here in the second quarter. 26-25. This is much like the third quarter when these teams match up at the end of the regular season, and a timeout by Coach Schwab. And Coach Schwab is not happy right now.
I can't tell if he's not happy with the officials or if he's not happy with his players, but he's clearly not happy, and I think perhaps it's the players.
Yeah, the conversation in the huddle right now is not a pleasant one if you're on the Garrigan side. So this is going to be an attention-grabbing moment for Garrigan.
That's right. Seeing
right now the first adversity in the playoffs for this group that is really, you know, they've seen obviously the state experience last year, but now the role players are becoming the main players this year, and they're really in charge of getting past this adversity tonight.
Yeah, and of course, anything can happen in the playoffs. You know, Bears highly favored here, but anything can happen. Not too worried so far. These girls, they have really responded every time they have a bad stretch and Coach Schwab calls timeout and wakes them up. They always come back favorably, and I expect them to do so here. But what he's upset about is while the Bears are forcing turnovers, they're turning the ball over themselves. They are not taking care of the ball as they usually do.
This is a Garrigan team that turns it over the least amount of time to the top of Iowa West.
They're going to call a carry. I think they called a carry on the guard. I think that was Aulish that had the ball.
It was Aulish that had the ball. I got to be honest, I really didn't see a carry there, but that is what they signaled.
The official made the motion of a carry, but now it seems like it's just some sort of a disagreement on something procedural.
Well, in any case, Whatever it is, North Iowa has the basketball right now, and Garrigan will bring the press back out. Beekler in the middle of the court, lobs it up ahead towards Hoffman, a fingertip catch as she powers into the front court, bounce pass underneath Langfold. She shoots off, oh, she puts it in and draws the foul. North Iowa's in the lead, and a chance for a three-point play by Langfold.
Wow, that was a great play by Langfold. I think she shot that with her left hand. She picks up a little foul from Alish, and that'll be the second one on Stacia Alish as the three-point play is successful. She makes the free throw.
Free throw, nothing but net for Langfold. 28-26, North Iowa. How about this turn of fortunes? Bishop Garrigan was up 21-9 at one point. Since that time, though, a 19-5 scoring edge by the Bison. That is the run they are currently enjoying right now. Capacious deep in the left wing, looking towards Montag in the high post. Whips it near side to Hoagland. Now it's Bartolo. Bartolo driving in, losing balance, and that's because she was pushed and fouled. Number five against North Iowa comes with 1:42 left. That one going against North Iowa as, well, they signaled Binken, they meant Beekler. They signaled 21 and they meant 12. That's number two on Beekler. I was going to say, Binken is not on the floor right now, even though that's who they announced that the free throw goes down.
You know, two fouls in the first half, not a big deal. Three is. So we got a lot of players out there playing with two fouls. They got to get another minute and 42 without picking their third up.
Bartolo misses the second one off the back of the cup. Rebound the flex out to Bartolo, though. Beyond the perimeter right now, she'll hand it off to Capacious. Far side of the court, dribbles right around the arc. Hoagland now right back to Capacious. High post to Montag. Quick pass to Bartolo. Lets it fly. And off the front of the cup on the three. Rebound Eastman. Shovels it back into Hoagland, who brings it back out. Now it's Montag looking to Eastman. Knock away by Langfold, but the ball goes right to Hoagland in the right corner. Garrigan have plenty of time. 1:18 left in the first half. Ball knocked away from Hoagland. Last touch by North Iowa.
A gamer is Beekler. Hoagland was holding the ball in the triple threat position, looking for someone to pass to him. Beekler said, you know what, I'm not going to get the ball, but I'm just going to swat it out of your hands. That's the kind of aggressiveness that the Bison are doing that makes Garrigan hesitate on their usual moves.
Bartolo tried to underhand it to Eastman. Sloppy pass knocked away. Tie up along the perimeter and a jump ball. Garrigan keeps possession with 1:10 left in the first half.
Well, that was a good call on the tie up. The official looked like he was about ready to blow a foul call there. Probably Stacia Alish, I think. But I'm sorry, on Hoagland, but changed his mind and made it a jump. That was a benefit.
Golden Bears desperately looking for a bucket right now. Hoagland on the right side. Bishop Garrigan trails North Iowa 28-27. It has been a long time since the Bears were defeated by the Bison. And they're about to go into half down here if they can't find a bucket. Capacious drives in left side. Layup no good. Rebound Eastman. Put back. We'll roll in. Garrigan back up by one.
Oh, a huge rebound by Eastman. She got that in the forest of Bison there. They were all around her. She went up and got it.
14 points by Eastman as Montag able to rake the ball out of bounds and dislodges from Hoffman as North Iowa will keep it. Murphy will check in for Bishop Garrigan as Murphy will come to get Zoe Montag.
Boy, you know, the other thing that Eastman offensive rebound putback does is it picks up your teammates. Capacious just made a great drive to the basket, missed the easy shot. She was frustrated, but knowing that Eastman is there, got the rebound, no harm done. It just really good teamwork there.
29-28, Bishop Garrigan, it's Hoffman. Dribbles towards the right, now switches towards the left. Bartolo nearly had the knockaway. Now she does knock it away. It rolls into the backcourt. Price can pick that up, though, because it was deflected. And she'll get it over to the right side to Eichenberger. 12 on the shot clock. Eichenberger on the right wing. Eichenberger, bounce pass corner to Job with 8 seconds on the shot clock. Garrigan playing good defense here. 5 seconds on the shot clock into Langfold. Knocked away again. Ball's just of two with one, and the shot clock is up. Ball is going out of bounds anyways, and yep, that's a 35-second violation as Garrigan gets it back with 13 seconds.
Well, what a defensive effort there by the Bears. The Bison were trying everything they could. They were dribbling, passing, looking, moving. They were running good offense, but the Bears, better defense.
8 seconds left in the first half. Capacious left side of the court with five. Wings across to Bartolo. She'll let it rip. At the end of the half, book it! Nothing but net for Emmy Bartolo. And the first half is over. A big three-point shot to grab a little momentum back. And Bishop Garrigan will take a 32-28 lead into the halftime locker room. We will step aside for a timeout. Break it all down next on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
Thank you to these postseason sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Helmers Insurance Agency. Stop by for an insurance quote today.
Central Financial Group, where you belong.
Your local Red Power team in Bancroft, Corwith, West Bend, and Humboldt.
Shoemaker Well and Water Care. They know water from the bottom of the tap.
Al Lobig Marine and Wesley, Hampton Boats and Mercury Outboards.
Lent's Funeral Home, someone who cares and understands.
All sponsors of this postseason game broadcast.
Is your student athlete on the injured list? we can help. This is Wendy Wagner, physical therapy assistant at Kossuth Regional Health Center. As a former student athlete and coach, I want to help you get back in the game feeling healthy and injury-free. Our staff works closely with local healthcare providers and specialists throughout the area for a recovery plan that works for you. Best of luck to all our area athletes this season. We will be cheering for you.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, your home for healthcare.
We've got more postseason sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Stroman Family Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Redding Gravel and Excavating, serving Algona and the surrounding area since 1948.
Johnny's Bar and Grill in Wesley, all-you-can-eat roasted chicken on Tuesday nights.
Vasky Sales and Service in Bancroft.
Bob Becker Construction with Wesley Lumber, building your dream home.
Granjanet Jewelry, think inside the box.
All sponsors of this postseason game broadcast. When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine postseason sports club members.
State Line Cooperative, real people, real pride.
Goshi Custom Cabinets in Bancroft.
Dietering Brothers in Bancroft, farm equipment, sales and service.
Steyer Ag Aviation, here for all your agronomy needs.
Steinman Insulation and Roofing in Wesley.
Lance and Tracy Ludwig, your channel seed dealer in Wesley.
All sponsors of this postseason game broadcast.
In farming, there are many risks and hazards that cannot be controlled. However, you can control how you protect your crops with insurance. Hi, this is Jason Bradley, agent with PMC Advantage Insurance Services in Algona. We help insure your crops against the elements and the unknown. At PMC Advantage, several agents can obtain the insurance you need to cover your crops properly. Coverage is offered through Farmers Mutual Hail, NAU Country, and ProAg, which allow us to provide multi-peril, hail, wind, green snap, and many more coverages. For your crop insurance needs, contact Jason Bradley, Jim Black, or Alex Bluer, or call 515-295-9433, or stop by the Algona or West Bend offices. PMC Advantage Insurance Services, a Pharmacist Mutual Insurance Company.
Time here at Bishop Garrigan High School as the Golden Bears, the back-to-back defending state champions, getting all they can handle in their first postseason test, as right now Bishop Garrigan leads North Iowa 32-28. Our video streaming broadcast here on Hometown Radio KLGA and the Algona Radio YouTube page, presented in part by Iowa State Bank, where they help people succeed. Come to Auto Center, where it's not just about the car, it's about the care. Bauer Plumbing and Heating of Emmitsburg and Algona. Algona Frame and Auto Body, where we meet by accident. PMC Advantage Insurance Services, where having the advantage makes all the difference. And Algona Municipal Utility, community-owned for community benefit. The scoring by quarter saw Bishop Garrigan take an 18-9 lead at the end of one. However, North Iowa outscored the Golden Bears 19-14 during that second quarter. Graceland Eastman has scored 14 so far tonight for Garrigan, as Emmy Bartolo second on the team with 8. Right now, though, the three-pointers just not dropping for Bishop Garrigan. They only made one free in the first half, and it was not for lack of trying. The turnovers have been sloppy so far. Both teams have some severe turnover issues in the first half, as both teams have played defense very aggressively so far tonight. And it's created a wild back-and-forth game, a great atmosphere here at Bishop Garrigan High School, and the back-to-back defending state champions, Beanie, getting a big test here to start off their postseason run this year.
Oh, yeah, for sure. You know, this team has had some challenges this year, and the Bison are bringing another one to them, so it's fun, but a lot of faith in these girls. It's a young team, but they're an experienced team. So that experience will pay off, like we saw in the last possession of the first half. You know, no panic in the veins of Emmy Bartolo. Garrigan had 8 seconds left. They get the ball to Capacious, the only senior out there on the floor at the time. And she runs a set play called by Coach Schwab, I'm sure, where they run a little screen that gets Emmy Bartolo open for the three-pointer. And she shoots it, swishes it. And that's just kind of the team that the Bears have here. Every time the going gets tough, these girls have stepped up and answered the call, like was exemplified there at the end of this first half. So, you know, this Garrigan team, they're a really good bunch of working together. You can see as they play the game, you've got Capacious to Eastman and these multiple guards playing together. I feel like when the Garrigan team really comes together, they are hard to beat. But they've turned the ball over a lot, which is very uncharacteristic.
Yes, and that brings up another important point that I was going to bring up. This Garrigan team is ranked number 5 in the state right now, and I don't think anyone would doubt when Bishop Garrigan is playing their best basketball with this year's team, they are capable of going back to state. No doubt about that. But the range of outcomes is much wider than it was in years past. They're also capable of being upset here in the first round by North Iowa if they can't clean up the turnovers in the second half. This is a Bison team, Beanie, that is substantially better than the Bison team of the past couple of years. A lot of senior experience with Miriam Binkin, the junior experience with Ashlyn Beekler leading the way, and some young freshmen mixing in there as well. This Bison team's made a lot of improvement, and, you know, Garrigan, they're kind of used to coasting through the first couple of postseason games, but this year's not going to be the same way. Garrigan has that back-to-back state champion target on their back. Even though they went 22 in the regular season, teams still feel this is the year we can upset Garrigan.
Yeah, absolutely. Boy, if I was a high school kid and I saw Audie Crooks and Molly Joyce graduate, I would say, finally, we have a chance, because against those two girls, boy, it was slim pickings. But with those two girls off to college, you think we've finally got a chance. But this is a very good Garrigan team. Has been fighting off challengers every step of the way, and doing it in very good fashion. Only a few close games this year. That loss to Forest City, a loss to Newell Fonda. But other than that, Garrigan's been pretty dynamic with their wins. But it all comes down to the game on the night that is played, and tonight, the Bison and the Bears having a great matchup here. And like you said, Tyler, the Bison haven't had, well, I'll just be blunt, they haven't had the best teams the last few years. They've struggled kind of around the horn in multiple sports in the girls' realm. But you can see that this team is young, and they got some young players, and they are here to play, and they're going to be good in the future those next few years. So that's good to see, because 1A girls basketball has kind of been a story of the haves and have-nots. We've seen a lot of the same teams down at state, and you either got the team or you don't, and it'd be great to see some more parity in the 1A basketball girls ranks.
We're seeing a little parity so far in tonight's matchup as Bishop Garrigan leads 32-28 at the half. Bino, how do you put on your coaching hat here? How are you approaching this if you're the two coaches? If you're Bishop Garrigan, Coach Schwab, and if you're North Iowa, Coach Meyer, how are you approaching this at halftime with your two teams? You know, if you're Coach Meyer on the brink of possibly upsetting the back-to-back state champions, if you're Coach Schwab, you're saying, hey, we've got to turn it on in the second half, much as we did in the fourth quarter last time these two teams matched up.
Well, I think if you're the Bison, you've really got to be imploring your team to don't let the game get fast-paced. If it gets fast-paced and Garrigan starts shooting rhythm threes and getting run-out layups by Bartolo and company, then it's going to get away in a hurry. You want to stay within striking distance. They're within striking distance right now. They're only down 4 points. If they can keep it close, give themselves a chance to win, that's the best they can ask for. But they're not going to win a track meet against the Bears. So they want to keep this game slow and controlled. Bears, on the other hand, I think Coach Schwab is just going to say, don't try to do too much. They're trying to push it a little too much, and they're turning the ball over because of it. Just be patient. Take the opportunities when they present themselves. Go for the steals when that ball's hanging out in front of your eyes. Don't try to push and pick up fouls. And don't try to do anything that you haven't done before. And I think they'll be just fine.
Well, this game really feels like a Friday night game, the kind of atmosphere you've seen so far tonight. A great atmosphere at Bishop Garrigan High School. And right now, a 32-28 lead by the Golden Bears at the half. We'll step aside for a timeout. Second half of basketball coming up in 2 minutes on 92.7 KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
We've got more postseason sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
The Market. Be happy. Shop the Market.
Nielsen Trucking. Your project is their priority.
Innovation Salon and Spa for your Aveda and massage needs.
Wine and Spirits, locally owned at 111 South Phillips Street.
J&J Custom Meats, located in Woodmore.
Roffer Electric, don't be left in the dark. Call 295-7117 today.
Bringing you this postseason game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Financial investments are very important, but so are the investments of time, patience, and encouragement our young athletes receive from their coaches, teachers, and mentors. That's why Edward Jones is a proud sponsor of high school sports coverage on Hometown and Home Country Radio. Contact Bruce Keith, Jerry Sokup, Mackenzie Jorgensen, or Brady Ross, your local Edward Jones financial advisors, for all your investment needs. Edward Jones, member SIPC. Thank you to these postseason sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Semco International, matting by design.
Flipside in Laverne, open 7 days a week, dine in or carry out.
Capacious Brothers Incorporated, Pioneer Seed.
Advanced Drainage Systems, our reason is water.
Lichter's Garage Opener Service and Appliance Repair. The City of Algona, now accepting applications for the Algona Aquatic Center, an equal opportunity employer.
Making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Getting ready to start the second half here on Hometown Radio KLGA and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream. It's a top of Iowa West battle, playoff style. Third time this season, the Golden Bears and the Bison have matched up. And right now, Bishop Garrigan leading North Iowa 32-28. That second quarter by the Bison, very reminiscent of the third quarter when these teams matched up at the end of the regular season. Bison got the Golden Bear lead in that game down to 4 points, but eventually the Golden Bears blew it open and won 67-42. Will that be the same script tonight, or will North Iowa pull the road upset and end the three-peat hopes for Bishop Garrigan? We will find out as the Bison will have the basketball starting off the second half, moving from left to right on the radio dial. We are rolling 32-28, Bishop Garrigan. Bison outscored the Golden Bears 19-14 during the second quarter as Miriam Binken back in as she plays the three personal fouls. Into the right corner, Joe, back into Binken, working against Eastman. She heads left, shot up, and it rolls off the back of the iron. Capacious rebound. Bison lament a missed opportunity. Garrigan has got to come help Capacious. She's in trouble back there and got it off to Bartolo, and Bartolo gets it ahead before the 10 seconds. Montag left of the paint, pass into Eastman. Clean catch, off glass, and count it.
Oh, good offense. North Iowa had some good offense. I'm very impressed with Binken. You know, North Iowa did all that without her in the second quarter.
The knockaway by Montag, ball out of bounds, and it will stay on the Garrigan side of things, or excuse me, on the North Iowa side of things.
And now that Binken's back in, her and Eastman both targeted in each team's first possession.
Well, that was a great job by North Iowa surviving without Binken, because in the first quarter, that was when Garrigan went on the big run. As the ball is kicked out of bounds, it will stay with the Bison again. Binken had to sit for a little bit during the first quarter. Garrigan made a big push during that time, but not only did North Iowa survive without Binken on the floor in a second, they thrived as the ball is walked over to the right baseline. Buechler will be the inbounder as North Iowa puts one player at each corner of the paint. Buechler looks, nothing open initially, and she'll get it in near side towards Joe beyond the perimeter. Now at the foul line, it's Binken, works her way in, shoots over Eastman, and she swishes it. Binken makes it 34-30, a four-point ball game right now in favor of the Golden Bears. Into the corner, it's Aulish looking in for Eastman, trying to seal off against Langfall. Eastman got the catch, and she drew the foul. That's on the floor.
Well, that was fantastic defense by Buechler. They got the lob pass into Eastman, but as soon as she caught the ball, the double team was there, and they were fortunate. Garrigan was fortunate to get a foul called there.
Aulish on the baseline, gets it into Eastman on the right side beyond the perimeter, and she shuffled the shoes as she started to drive. That travel's been called tightly on both sides so far tonight. Job's been called for a few for North Iowa. Garrigan's had a variety of players called for at least one travel so far in this game. As Job brings it across half court, Job averaging 6.8 points per game for the Bison. Now it's Hoffman, pass knocked away by Bartolo, who's been extremely active on defense so far, but Hoffman got it back. Sidearms the pass inside to Langfall, shoots over Eastman, and she erased it. Ball went to Binken, though, and Binken fouled from behind. Looks like Montag was the guilty party that time, as Eastman had the block, but a friendly bounce for North Iowa.
Well, it was actually best-case scenario there for North Iowa.
Well, they will get Eastman on that one, her first.
Is that Langford is shorter than Eastman, and really had no chance to shoot that shot over the top of her, and it kind of gets blocked, She lost it right into the hands of Binken, who does have the height. And now she's at the free throw line, makes her first one. It's 34-31. Second one is good as well, 34-32. Two-point game, 6:48 left in the third.
Well, making free throws in the second half is going to be big for the Bison. They were eighth out of nine teams at the top of Iowa West this season. Under 52% on free throws as Binken fronted Eastman and intercepted the pass. Binken at the top of the key, she'll head right. She's driving in, got by Montag, got to the rack and scored it. We are tied at 34.
Oh, and she gets some really well-earned applause from the North Iowa crowd. They're on their feet for that great move by Binken.
Yeah, having a big who can handle the basketball is a huge asset as Montag lets it rip, count the three-pointer.
A couple huge threes, one by Bartolo at the end of the half. Now Montag, that's a big answer to go up by 3 points.
5 points by Montag, Binken from the lane, bounces on the cup three times and drops through. Binken, 1 point game again.
Binken is flowing, they gotta keep giving her that ball. She's hot, gotta get it to her.
13 points so far by Binken for North Iowa, and we've got a whistled by the officials and a clock issue here. Actually, a net issue. The net is all wrapped up in the basket after that Montag swish as Bacon goes up and takes it herself.
You know, we saw about three stoppages last night in the boys' game versus West Hancock here in this gym. I might have to come into school early tomorrow morning and put a new net up there, one that's a little stiffer, because that net is flopping around up there and getting caught on the rim. And that does make a difference, because now the Bears get a chance to reset their play.
Well, Beanie, I thought you were going to say you had to come into the gym and shoot some three-pointers yourself as Montag shoots the three, rims out, no good. Rebound by Capacious, and she'll fire it to the cutting Montag. It's off her foot. It rolls into the backcourt, and it's going out of bounds. And they say North Iowa touched it.
Interesting. Yeah. Well, no one's arguing. Well, Tyler, if they need to loosen up the rims, I can do that because I only hit the rims and the backboards, but rarely do my shots ever touch the net.
You're giving yourself a lot of credit saying you'd be able to hit the rim on a
three-point shot.
Hey,
come on.
As Marsfolo brings it across half court. There's a breeze in this gym whenever Beanie Bodie shoots the basketball, ladies and gents. It's refreshing. Capacious down the lane. The poke away by Hoffman. Capacious controlled the rock. Ball rotates around to Bartolo. Her three-pointer off the heel. Deflects all the way out. And Aulish chases down the board near half court.
Well, the Bears have gotten two consecutive offensive rebounds and each time set up a whole new possession. Really working to get an open shot.
Yeah, rebounding those threes. Definitely big for the Garrigan offense throughout the season. Bartolo in between the circles finds Capacious at the foul line. Looks underneath to Eastman. Catches but not cleanly. She turns around for a jumper. It got tipped. Binken trying to save it, and it is out of bounds. Oh. Last touch by the North Iowa senior.
Wow, Binken, it goes off her fingertips, and that was because Abby Capacious was right behind her trying to tip at that rebound, and she didn't foul her, but her presence right behind her made Binken step forward and knock it out of bounds. Bears are having a fourth shot on goal here after the offensive rebounds, and now they're taking it out under bounds. Now the officials are talking. I think they might flip this over and give it to North Iowa. They might say Capacious touch it. No, they are going to let it stay. They just want to talk about it, I guess.
Well, Aulish will be the inbounder for Bishop Garrigan. Aulish from the far side baseline with 5:05 left in the third quarter. 15 on the shot clock for the Golden Bears. The possession did not change. Capacious catches along the baseline, but the ball is low, and it's touching the baseline out of bounds.
Yeah, she had to catch that one down by her ankles. Not the cleanest of passes, and she caught it, touched the sphere on the line.
All right, Beanie, hold everything.
Hold everything.
We've got some serious strategy going on right now.
What's going
on? The North Iowa student section is switching sides. They started on the right side. Now they're heading to the left. The left is where Garrigan's going to be shooting free throws, so this is a big reversal here.
Oh,
that's great game planning by the Bison. They are prepared for the playoffs.
That's an intelligent student section. Hats off to that thinker.
High basketball IQ play right there by the North Iowa student section. And I'm not even joking, folks. That is a great move by the Bison. We'll see how the Golden Bears student section responds. Binken driving along the baseline. She's staying in bounds. Tries to reverse. Capacious blocks, but also a foul on Garrigan. And if that's on Capacious, that is going to be number three.
Oh, Capacious picks up her third foul, and she is never really one to show emotion against officials. But she says, oh, no, on that one, because she had all ball. But she's going to pick up her third. And she is the linchpin to this Garrigan team, the senior, number 21.
Binken's free throw rubber rims into the cup, and we are tied at 37. Second free throw, Binken. That pops out. Rebound by Capacious. Abby Capacious averaging nearly 11 boards per game this season for Garrigan. Has 14 games of 10 or more rebounds this season, and maybe approaching that tonight already. Aulish sidearms the pass to the right wing to Bartolo. Looking inside for Eastman. Makes a great catch. Finishes off glass.
What a pass by Bartolo. Beautiful placement of that ball. 39-37. Capacious guarding Binken. So two players with three fouls against each other.
18 points by Eastman so far is barreling away inside for North Iowa is Alexis Gray, who we're seeing for the first time in this ballgame. Now to Binken on the left elbow. Binken works the dribble. Binken pivoting it past Capacious. Puts up a tough shot and missed it left. Gray tries to track it down and throw it in, but she stepped out along that Bishop Garrigan baseline.
Well, you can see the confidence that Coach Schwab has in Capacious. I just mentioned earlier in this quarter how Binken is hot. They can't stop her, and Coach Schwab goes to man-on-man, puts Capacious on her, and she hasn't scored since. I find myself looking at Capacious' shoes now that we know she hasn't had new shoes in 4 years.
Did we know that? That's new information to me, but Capacious, I'm not surprised by that as Aulish lets the three-pointer rip. It's off the heel, long deflection, and it's chased down by Hoffman. Ready-made fast break. Hoffman running the floor. Hoffman layup, no good, and Capacious grabs the rebound. Garrigan dodges the bullet as Bartolo did a great job staying in front of Hoffman.
Good hustle by the Bears to get back. Good hustle by the Bison to get back on defense right now.
Montag from way downtown, rims out on the three. Rebound near side by Aulish, and she'll bring it back outside towards Bartolo. Bartolo flings it over to right to Montag. Looks inside, nothing there. Golden Bears rotate it left to Bartolo, and back to the right to Montag. Eyes the bucket, tries again. That one's off the heel too. Rebound by North Iowa, briefly controlled, but it's off the hands and deflected away as Garrigan has it again. Bartolo drives in, looks for Eastman. Pass intercepted, and North Iowa finally has it. It's Hoffman into the front court with 3:06 left in the third quarter. Stops on the right wing. Looking to the edge of the paint to Eichenberger. Now onto the foul line to Binken. Binken working past Eastman. Eastman stays in front, but Binken spotted it anyways, and we are tied at 39.
Really good body control and finishing moves there by Binken. We got a game, 2:50 left to go in the third. This is exciting, folks. Thanks for tuning in.
For those of you just tuning in, at one point, Garrigan was winning this game 21-9. Things have changed dramatically since then. Coach Rick Meyer and the Bison trying for a massive road upset here in Algona, Iowa. Montag in the right corner, gets it to Bartolo. Wide open tray, rims out again. Rebound Eastman, Eastman put back, no good. Capacious rebound on the third opportunity. She'll kick out to Allish, catch and shoot three. Missed it left. Rebound by Binken, and North Iowa dodges the bullet. Here comes the center striding across half court. Binken taking it herself, scoops it up. She'll draw the foul. That is Capacious, and that is number four.
Coach Swab knew he was rolling the dice, leaving Capacious in, but she's got so much experience. She's going to see how far she can go. Now she's going to have to go in as Murphy and Hoagland are set to come in and get Capacious out with her fourth foul. Boy, how about Miriam Binken here for North Iowa? She hits her free throw there. She is, I haven't seen her play every game this year, but I can't imagine she's played many games better than she's playing right now. She is having a whale of a game here for the Bison. And that's with three fouls that she picked up early there.
She sat for a long period of time, about 4 minutes in the second quarter. Binken is playing like a player desperate not to let their season and career end as she'll knock down the free throw. 41-39 North Iowa, 15 points so far by Binken as Garrigan has the ball down by two again. We've seen the lead change hands a couple of times so far tonight. Between the circles, it's Bartolo, gets it right to Allish. On the right wing, finding Eastman high post. Top of the key towards Bartolo. She'll drive in. She'll look for Eastman. Rolls to the bucket and scores. We are tied at 41.
Oh, that was pretty. Emmy Bartolo, what a drive and dish to Eastman. A little lob over the top.
20 points by Grayson Eastman. Inside Langfall catches. Shoots over Murphy, left it short. Oh, a point-blank opportunity for North Iowa they couldn't capitalize on. And the ball is out of bounds and back to Garrigan.
Oh, and Coach Meyer for the Bison and the whole Bison crowd says that is an egregious error by the officials. They thought for sure that went off the Bears. But the officials say the ball goes to the Garrigan. Here comes their offense.
Alyssa Hoagland standing on the left wing right now, takes one dribble and flings it across towards Allish right side. 1:33 left in the third, all tied at 41. Back to left to Hoagland, arcs up the three off the front of the rim. Rebound by Allish, and she'll take it back out to the far side of the court. Fresh 35 for Garrigan, Bartolo off the dribble. Floater from the foul line, and pops out of the cup.
Well, nothing's going down for the Bears now. They just gotta stay the course and keep playing hard defense, but wow. This is getting really exciting here in the gym.
Here's Hoffman working against Hoagland, left the ball behind. Bartolo trying to dive in and get it. They got the pass right to Beekler. Beekler free, a little bit too strong. Rebound to Murphy along the perimeter.
Oh, that was right on target, just a little strong. The crowd would have went crazy.
Dangerous pass, intercepted in the lane. It's stolen by Eichenberger. Here she comes, Eichenberger up the near side. It's one on three. Murphy trying to steal it. Ball rolls between Eichenberger's legs, but she got out to Langfald. And then Langfald lost it, out of bounds, but Garrigan touched it last. And now the Garrigan crowd is upset.
That might have been a payback call for the other one there. Boy, Langfald has been Johnny on the spot the last two possessions here for the Bison.
Into the corner, caught by North Iowa's Hoffman, finds Eichenberger inside. Eichenberger misses off glass to the right. Eastman tracks down a contested rebound. North Iowa's trying to swarm all the Garrigan rebounders as soon as they get the ball. Bartolo runs the floor, nice sidestep, spins it up and spins it in.
Oh, Emmy Bartolo has been the one with the answer in a lot of games this year. She's answering there. Eastman's owning the lane, Bartolo's owning the perimeter.
Double digits for Bartolo with 10 points. Bison have the rock right now, a lob towards Jobe near side. Jobe driving towards the baseline. She'll let the jumper rip. That one's off the front of the iron, and Eastman tracks down another contested board. Outlet towards Hoagland. Hoagland down the middle of the court, and she'll bring it out towards the left wing. 7 seconds left. Hoagland drives, floats, missed it. Rebound Beekler, 3 seconds. Lost it out of bounds of 1.9. Unforced error for Beekler, and Bishop Garrigan can get one more shot off before the end of the third.
Yeah, they have just enough time to catch and shoot the ball. They bring Capacious in with four fouls. They're going to run that lob. They're going to do a back screen for Capacious, lob the ball in for her, and she's going to kind of elevate it and jump it in.
Gear is Arlish from the baseline. Gets it into Capacious. Shields off the defender and scores right at the end of the third quarter. A physical play by Abby Capacious, and Bishop Garrigan is up by four. We're going to the fourth, ladies and gents. Garrigan trying to hang on. Will they do it? Find out next on KLGA 92.7.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine postseason sports club members.
Marceau's Golden Harvest Seed Sales, Jim Marceau.
Advanced Interior Care, professional home and business cleaning of carpet, ceramic floors, upholstery, and window treatments.
Algona Dairy Queen, enjoy your favorite DQ treats. They're open for the season.
Algona Hearing Center, better living through better hearing.
Stone and Steel, offering top-of-the-line customer service for your next countertop remodel or new home build.
All sponsors of this postseason game broadcast.
At Security State Bank, we focus on the needs of local families, businesses, and farmers. Decisions are made locally. We live and work in your neighborhood, helping to keep our local community vibrant and growing. We're involved in local community events. We believe in personalized service and advice that meets or exceeds your expectations. We're Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne. Bankers who believe in you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State Bank.
For the second night in a row, Bishop Garrigan fans, buckle your seatbelts. 45-41, Bishop Garrigan on top of North Iowa, heading to the fourth. All a three-pointer right off the horn, left it short. Rebound on the paint by Binken, and Garrigan stays ice cold on three-point shots. Pass to the baseline, Buechler. Buechler too deep to shoot it, trying to get space, trying to fade back. That's got to be a tie-up there. That is a tie-up. Jump balls, North Iowa has the possession.
Very good officiating down there. The official on the perimeter saw the tie-up, and he let the guy underneath know not to call a foul, that he saw the tie-up, and they conferred. Nice to see that great officiating there on that call.
North Iowa mounts to Job left wing. Job slicing in. Job floater blocked by Eastman. Ball went right to Langfeld, and then Murphy rips it out of her hands. She said, give me that.
Yeah, good defense by Murphy there. She's playing for the Capacious with four fouls. How long will they leave Abby Capacious on the bench? We'll see, but if Murphy plays good D, no reason to risk her.
North Iowa had to survive out Binken in the second quarter. Garrigan has to survive out Capacious for at least a few minutes here in the fourth as the ball is knocked out of bounds. Garrigan will keep it.
Boy, Garrigan has gotten so many multiple possessions each time down the floor, whether it's because of offensive rebound just good, solid play. Like, they've held the ball for a lot more seconds than North Iowa.
Garrigan has it right now between the circles of Bartolo. Left side to Olish, now back to Bartolo. Passing to Montag on the right side. Fakes towards the baseline, gets back up top to Bartolo. Job flies by. Pass goes left to Olish. Looking right to Bartolo again. Shot clock running out. Olish is going to hoist, and it's off the front of the iron. Rebound by Langfold, and Garrigan goes one and done.
Coach Swab still just wondering, why aren't the three-pointers going in? They have, I haven't kept the stats, but boy, are they way below percentage.
Here's a Job three-point ball. That one rolls off the rim. North Iowa really not shooting great on three-pointers either. And here comes Zoe Montag. Gets it up to Bartolo, now to Montag. Montag thought about pulling, and then she travels. Tried a hard head fake, and you can see a little frustration creeping in for the Garrigan Jr.
Yeah, she did such a big head fake. Sometimes that cues the official to get ready to call that travel. And Job's going to come out. Boy, the Bison have their A lineup in here. They've got their biggest lineup. I believe this is all their starters. So if they're going to make a go at it, it's right now, says Coach Meyer of the Bison.
The only non-star on the floor right now is Price, as Job will be on the bench. Working the dribbles, Hoffman. Hoffman spinning away from Bartolo, heads left of the paint, shoots over Eastman, and that is going to be a foul on Eastman. Two free throws coming for Becca Hoffman with 6:29 left in the fourth.
Boy, Becca Hoffman, great job driving hard to hoop. She's only 5'4", going into the lane against Eastman, who's got 4 inches plus on top of her, and gets herself to the free throw line, picks up a foul on Eastman, only her second here in this game.
Hoffman misses on the first one, just 26.5% from the foul line this season, and she'll try to make it a three-point game if she can knock down the second one. Hoffman free throw. Off the back of the iron, and Eastman collects the rebound and gets it near side to Olish.
Binken has to lay off on fighting for that rebound with her three fouls.
Montag up top to Olish. 6:20 left in the fourth quarter, and Bishop Garrigan clinging to a four-point lead. The number five-ranked Golden Bears lost just two games in the regular season, one to New Fonda and one against Forest City. Montag will release the three, but a three-second call against Garrigan before the three-pointer gets off.
Oh, Tyler, you know I love the three-second call. I think I love it because I got called for that so many times. I didn't like to move very much when I was in the basketball world, So that made a lot of 3 second calls.
2 minutes gone here in quarter number four. Couple passes or a couple bounces towards the right side, then the pass to Buechler. She'll get it off to Price. Price three-point ball is a little bit off the mark, and rebound by Montag.
One and done for the Bison. Reagan Murphy's wide open. Bammy Bartolo says, let's run the offense.
Allish into Eastman, high post, looking out towards Montag right side. Down to the baseline, Murphy tried to find a cutting Eastman, and it's swatted out of bounds by Binken. That's not a blocked shot, but that kind of feels like the force that she powered that one into the padding with.
Yeah, she swatted that, and Binken has a few words with her teammate, Buechler. You know, these teams, Garrigan, really good communication over the season. These good teams, when they're playing well, they're often communicating well.
Allish lobs it in towards Eastman, intercepted by Binken, playing great defense tonight. Up ahead to Job, and she overshot her out of bounds. That turnover bug comes back and bites North Iowa again of 5:37 left.
Oh, Binken knows she missed an opportunity there. She puts her head down, and here come the Bears. Fortunate to get that turnover. They're up four, stretching it out here with a three.
Allish, she'll take the three, and she'll cash it in. Huge three for Stacia Allish.
I could just see that coming. You can see it on Stacia Allish's face when she's lining up to drain one, and she does so there, a seven-point lead.
Allish, a 32% three-point shooter this year for Bishop Garrigan. She attempted 174 threes coming into tonight. For reference, Molly Joyce took 172 last year. Eastman knocks the pass away and takes it. Point being, Allish has put up a lot of three balls for Garrigan this season. The repetition is there. 5 minutes left in the fourth, 48-41 Golden Bears. Eastman in the post, working towards the right, pivots left, finds Murphy left baseline. Out to Montag, quick rotation around the perimeter. Allish right wing, shoots again, hits again! Nothing but net, Stacia Allish. 10-point lead just like that, and a full timeout called by North Iowa. The Bishop Garrigan sophomore coming up big in the clutch as we'll take a timeout on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Elgato Radio YouTube stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio, brought to you by these fine postseason sports club members.
Steyer Flooring, home of the Fluorinator.
Algona Feed Store, with all your feed needs.
River Road Golf Club, your friends are here.
Murphy Realty and Management, serving Algona and the surrounding area.
Nutrien Ag Solutions of Irvington and Laverne, for all your crop input needs.
Snap-on Tools, the most valued tool storage solutions in the world.
Postseason sports club members bringing you this game.
More postseason sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Emeralds, featuring your favorite steaks and seafood.
Sportsman's Corner, Can-Am and Honda side-by-sides, ATVs and motorcycles.
Good Samaritan Society, Algona. Senior housing and services rooted in God's love.
Carol Implement of Laverne, serving area farming communities for over 50 years.
Schindler Lawn Care and Landscaping. Call 515-320-3840.
Farmers Co-op of Addison and Algona, offering Kent Show feeds.
All sponsors of this postseason broadcast.
Gary the Bear getting the Bishop Garrigan student session fired up, and Stacia Allish getting the Bishop Garrigan offense fired up with two three-pointers, that is, here in the fourth quarter, making it a 51-41 game.
Back-to-back threes. I don't think she made one since that one she made in the first half. But, boy, Allish, talk about huge step up there, draining those shots. She wanted the ball, Tyler, calling for it that whole possession.
The threes have been few and far between tonight for Garrigan prior to those Allish three balls. And all of a sudden, it's a 10-point lead. North Iowa has stuck around all night. They're going to need one final run to upset the Golden Bears. But now down by 10. Game is on the line. Job gives it outside. It's a three-point ball. Hoffman off the front of the iron. Ball deflects to your side. And Job tracks it all the way down on a foul by Murphy.
Good hustle by Job. Oh, she was clear on the other side of the floor, where I think she might have shuffled her feet when she had the ball and got away with the travel. But, boy, she flies across the floor to get that loose ball. That is key if the Bison are going to make a run here in this fourth quarter with 4 minutes left.
Into the left corner, Hoffman tries again for a three-point ball. That's off the front of the iron, and this time Murphy snatches away the rebound from three black jerseys. It'll be Bartolo engineering the offense for Bishop Garrigan as she brings it across half court. We are halfway done in the fourth quarter. 51-41 Bishop Garrigan. Bartolo drives in right side, flips it back outside towards Montag. Dribbles left around the arc, bounce pass left baseline to Murphy. Lob into Eastman, center of the paint. Eastman heading right, takes a wide angle, shot rolls off the rim. Murphy offensive board.
Good rebound
Allish
by Murphy.
Bats up into the corner. Didn't pull it as North Iowa had a good closeout of Buechler. Ball goes across towards Bartolo right side, and she'll bring it back up top and reset for the Bishop Garrigan offense.
Oh, just great decision by Bartolo there. There's no reason. They have a 10-point lead. There's no reason to push a shot right now.
Clock is on your side as Eastman Can't make the catch cleanly. Has to go all the way to the corner to track down the loose ball and gets it out to Murphy. 10 on the shot clock. Murphy left side towards Bartolo. Deep tray, and it clangs off to the right. No good. Rebound picked up by North Iowa Eichenberger, and that'll be a foul on Garrigan, their third.
Well, Benkin had that ball in her hands, but Murphy just fighting for it so hard. Didn't know when to say when and head back down to the other end of the floor. But nothing hurt there. That's just three fouls on Garrigan here in the half.
3:19 left in the fourth quarter. North Iowa, no fouls so far this quarter after getting in a lot of foul trouble early in this game. A nice wraparound pass by Binken. She'll find Eichenberger for two.
Oh, really impressed with Binken's play. Talk about improvement over her years as a basketball player. Just having a great game here for the Bison.
And they needed it. Their leading scorer on the season, Ashlyn Beekler, at 10.6 points per game, has just three tonight. But Binken with 15 for the Bison, 51-43. Bartolo wants to drive, stops the foul line, gets it right side towards Montag. Montag across the left side of the lane, looking into Eastman, makes the catch, dribbles towards the right, bangs it off the window, no. Ball deflecting towards the baseline, picked up by Binken on the rebound.
Wow, what a pass by Montag. I thought she was going to shoot it, but she finds Eastman.
North Iowa has to get the tempo going here of 2:31 left. Job is going to arc up a three-pointer, and it bounces off the glass and the rim. No good. Offensive rebound peeled away from Eichenberger out of bounds. Last touch by Bishop Garrigan.
Boy, Eichenberger, good rebound. She turned towards the basket, but she had Beekler wide open for a three-pointer. Just didn't see her. And Coach Meyer wants to take a timeout with 2:25
left. 2:25
left.
We'll take one final timeout as well as you're listening to high school basketball on Hometown Radio, KLGA, and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
In farming, there are many risks and hazards that cannot be controlled. However, you can control how you protect your crops with insurance. Hi, this is Jason Bradley, agent with PMC Advantage Insurance Services in Algona. We help insure your crops against the elements and the unknown. At PMC Advantage, several agents can obtain the insurance you need to cover your crops properly. Coverage is offered through Farmers Mutual Hail, NAU Country, and ProAg, which allow us to provide multi-peril, hail, wind, green snap, and many more coverages. For your crop insurance needs, contact Jason Bradley, Jim Black, or Alex Bluer, or call 515-295-9433, or stop by the Algona or West Bend offices. PMC Advantage Insurance Services, a Pharmacist Mutual Insurance Company.
.225 left to the fourth. Left elbow jumper, Binken, short for North Iowa. Offensive board, Beekler, power dribble, put back up and in. Big bucket for North Iowa, six-point game.
Capacious back in there with four, and she had to let Beekler shoot that without contesting the shot. Didn't want to sit out the last 2 minutes of this game.
51-45, Bishop Garrigan trying to hang on the fourth. Getting a big test from the North Iowa Bison. Third matchup has been the closest between these teams so far, as it's gotten a little closer each time. Montag driving left side. Layup spins off, no. Eastman put back, no. Job almost had the rebound. Eastman got it back, though. Finds Montag, and Montag bounces it in.
Oh, nice little bounce by Montag. Coach Schwab says, no fouls, just play hard defense. The Bison almost had that rebound, but the Bears kept it alive, and now the Bison throw it away. Beekler tried to go cross-court, and it goes into the Garrigan student section.
Big turnover for the Bison of 1:41 left. That's been the theme all night. The turnovers for North Iowa, and the lack of three-point shooting on both sides, as Garrigan has hit a couple key three-pointers late, while the Bison have stayed cold on the three-point shots. 1:38 left. Garrigan can be very patient here at 53-45. Bartolo walks it across half court. Bartolo heads left and finds Allish on the wing, guarded by Beekler. Capacious pops out and collects the basketball in between the circles. As we said, winner of this game plays Friday night against either Newman Catholic or St. Ansgar, as Garrigan just has to hang on the final 1:20, up 53-45. 13 on the shot clock, it's Allish left side, guarded by Beekler, now back out to Bartolo. Bartolo wants to drive, Bartolo out of the paint, shovels to Eastman. Eastman pivots towards the bucket, shot rejected by Binken. Rebound Capacious, put back, no. Rebound by Binken again, of 1:07 left. Binken outlets down the floor, finds Hop underneath, a nice pass to Beekler. Beekler layup, no good. Rebound by Capacious and a foul with 1 minute left. That may have been the last chance for North Iowa. They had a wide open layup, but couldn't convert.
Oh, they had to have that layup, and they had to have that rebound a moment ago. that the Bears kept alive, just not rolling their way here at the end of the game for the Bison. But man, what an improvement this North Iowa Bison team has done over the last couple years and in this game.
Well, this Bison team, they've won 8 games this season as Bartolo drives and is fouled with 4:49 left. This is a Bison team that had won 6 games last year. The 4 years prior to that had won a 6 combined.
Wow, what an improved Bison squad this is. Yeah, timeout on the floor here. It's going to be a full timeout by the Bison.
We'll keep it here, 49 seconds left. Garrigan up 53-45.
Well, this is a tough one. If you're Coach Meyer, I know he's working so hard in that timeout trying to draw plays. They've gotten open shots, but they haven't been able to make them. Boy, they had an open one for Binken out of last timeout. They just didn't get the breaks here down the stretch. But, you know, at this point, all he can do is implore his team to just pull some sort of gutsy effort out and just be all over the Bears and hope for steals, because the fouling is not going to work because Garrigan's a pretty darn good free throw shooting team. This is one thing that makes these games more exciting, Tyler. There was no shot clock just as recent as a few years ago, and teams like Garrigan would just dribble out the whole fourth quarter with their good guards. But now with that shot clock, it sure makes these end-of-game situations a lot more exciting as teams have a chance to play good, hard defense and get the ball back.
That's a great point. It's hard to remember sometimes. This is just year 2 of the shot clock in high school basketball in the state of Iowa, and it does make the end of the games a lot more strategic. Your clock management has to be a lot better. You've really got to keep all that in mind down the stretch, the clock management, the foul management. So I'd say, any coach you talk to definitely likes the change.
For sure. I mean, if you have guards like Garrigan does, if you have an 8-point lead with 4 minutes left in the game, that's pretty secure because you can just run so much clock with your good ball handling, but not anymore.
Capacious inbounds into the backcourt to Bartolo. 49 seconds left, and North Iowa fouls quickly with Hoffman. That's going to be Hoffman's 4th, and team foul 3 against the Bison. So Hoffman can no longer foul for the Bison. Garrigan stacks up along the far side of the court. Capacious gets it into the backcourt to Bartolo. Nearly a steal by Hoffman as Bartolo weaves away. Hoffman doesn't want to foul, but she's got 4. North Iowa will have to do something eventually. Hoffman's trying for the steal, and she'll foul. That's number 5, and Hoffman is done with 39 seconds left.
Hoffman kind of hurt her ankle there a little bit. She doesn't realize it's her 5th foul. She's like, is that my 5th, really? She doesn't realize how fast they're racking up there at the end of the game. Boy, Tyler, Hoffman gets the foul call there. She's going to exit. Senior gets a standing ovation from the Bison crowd. There's always some upset faces when she comes out, gets hugs from her teammates.
Yeah, it's always the tough part at the end of the season. Now 38 seconds left. A valiant effort by Hoffman and the North Iowa Bison, but looks like it's going to come up just short tonight as they will foul Garrigan with 34 seconds left. And that should be number 5, and it is, as Garrigan will shoot 2.
And hats off to Hoffman there. Like, she played a great game. Good job by that young woman. And she was there on that last possession guarding Bartolo up really close. I think it's always tough for me in the end of game situations what constitutes a 5-second call and what doesn't, because you see it in college and the high school ranks. It seems like people can dribble around for way more than 5 seconds closely guarded, and the refs kind of let it go.
Bartolo misses on the first foul shot. 34 seconds left. Second free throw goes down the drain. 54-45, Bishop Garrigan, and Coach Schwab is going to take a 30-second timeout, make sure everything's in order. 20 points tonight by Gracelyn Eastman, 11 by Emmy Bartolo, and 9 by Sasha Aulish. Beanie, we talked about it all season long, the 3-point shooting by the Garrigan guards, and it's come and gone at times, but tonight it came back at the most important time. It was cold all night, but those 2 3-pointers by Sasha Aulish really changed the entire game here in the 4.
Totally agree. I think if Aulish doesn't hit those 2 3-pointers, we could be in a last-second situation here, coming down to the wire here. But boy, those 3-pointers really, really, not just did they change the scoreboard in favorable way for the Bears, but it kind of put the entire Bear team at ease a little bit, and they could get back to their normal game here. Coach Schwab here, coaching down the stretch, he made a comment the other day when we interviewed him that was both funny but also true. He used to say, boy, the last couple of years, when the game gets close, we just have a timeout and say, just get the ball in the Audi, and then you just watch it happen. And he said, can't do that anymore. I know I have to really coach my butt off in these situations, and he's doing that tonight. Making sure they know exactly what to do in the last few seconds of this game.
Coming out of the timeout, North Iowa will have the basketball, 34 seconds left, and a 54-45 lead by Bishop Garrigan, trying to move on to Friday night. It's Job up the near side of the court for the Bison, striding into the front court. Job stops in the wing, gives up to Beekler. Desperation free by Beekler, left it short. Ball is heading towards the boundary. It's out of bounds, and Garrigan has it back of 25 seconds left.
Now, will the Bison foul, extend this game, or are they going to let the Bears dribble it out? Because I haven't seen teams come back from nine with 25 seconds ever.
They are going to foul. They'll foul Bartolo in the backcourt, and she will head to the stripe. Well, Bishop Garrigan, you'd say that's a good person to get the ball to, but really anyone on the floor is a good person for Garrigan to get the ball to. They really don't have a three-throw shooter that you're saying, well, you've got to foul this person because they're going to miss. That really doesn't exist on this Garrigan team.
No, pretty solid up and down the lineup on their free-throw shooting, and that's just a sign of the time that these shooters put in on the gym. And, you know, you're a coach and you come into the gym, you kind of look at free throw percentages right away, and then you know what kind of team you're dealing with.
Both free throws good for Bartolo. She has 13, and Bishop Garrigan up by 11. 23 seconds and taking left. Beekler heading towards the right. Beekler slicing in. Beekler float over Eastman, banks it in. 56-47 with 15 seconds left. Bison will take their final timeout.
Look
It'll
at
be
that.
A full 60 here to try to set something up with 14 seconds left. But Beanie, resilient effort tonight for the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. I'm not sure they wanted the game to come down this close to the end, but this is going to be a test that carries forward later in the playoffs. If the game gets close again at the end, they'll say, well, we've done it once in the playoffs so far. We can try to do it again.
Well, you know, look, yeah, for sure. Yeah, they can do it again. But look at these Bison coaching and playing up to the very last second. This is an impossible comeback at this point, but they are not going to stop coaching and trying. What an impressive effort by the North Iowa Bison. Hats off to them here. And you know what that does, Tyler, is there's a few little girls here in the crowd watching for the Bison, and they are going to think, you know what, that looks kind of fun. I think I'd like that challenge. Garrigan's going to have that going now. Now it's really solid with their program. They've got all kinds of young players that want to take the shoes on. And speaking of shoes, Abby Capacious has thrown it in here for the Bears.
Gets it into Bartolo. Bartolo weaves between two defenders. And the Bison are going to circle next year's matchups against Bishop Garrigan on that calendar. Final 10 seconds. The Golden Bears bring it back out. It was a valiant effort tonight by the North Iowa Bison. They gave Bishop Garrigan everything they could handle. But the back-to-back state champions have a win in the books in the playoffs. 56-47 the final score. A couple clutch three-pointers by Stacia Allish down the stretch. Good defense and rebounding by the Golden Bears. Proved to get the job done. The win tonight is number 21 of the season for Coach Schwab and his squad. North Iowa will end the season at 8-15 as they fall for the third time to Bishop Garrigan. We'll take a timeout. We'll get the final numbers coming up next on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the El Gordo Radio YouTube live stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine postseason sports club members.
Dump It. They do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Greg Petting and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Neil Albert Electric. Flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Kemco Tires, your Goodyear tire dealer.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country. Highway 18, just west of Algona.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Postseason sports club members bringing you this game.
A big bank can deliver the products you need and the convenience you expect. A small bank can make you feel like family. At Fidelity Bank and Trust, we don't think you should have to choose. Your hometown bankers have roots here. We understand the community and why you want to live here. Because we live here too. We're big enough to deliver, yet small enough to care. Fidelity Bank and Trust, your hometown bank. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Your hometown Fidelity Bank and Trust, located in Bancroft, Iowa.
Thank you to these postseason sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Purpling Boyd & Company, CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Algona Livestock Auction, sales every Monday.
American Glass, for all your glass needs, think American.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, with two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, check their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Postseason sports club members bringing you this game.
At Wiffles Hybrids, they're completely focused on developing and producing the very best sea corn on the planet. It's an act they've been polishing for more than 70 years, right here in the heart of the Corn Belt. Wiffles Hybrid, one thing done right. For more information, contact Rich Rosenmeyer, Dale Lappy, or Mitchell Carroll at JDR Seed of Wesley, 515-341-2452, or visit wiffles.com.
Final score tonight from Bishop Garrigan High School. The back-to-back defending state champion Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears survive a test from North Iowa Bison 56-47. That is your final score on the Greg Penning & Company Certified Public Accountant Scoreboard. The scoring by quarter looked like this. Bishop Garrigan jumped out to an 18-9 lead at the end of one. North Iowa had a 19-14 scoring advantage in the second quarter as the score is 32-28 in favor of the Bears at halftime. Both teams scored 13 points in the third as Bishop Garrigan led by four going to the fourth. Then the Golden Bears closed, outscoring the Bison 11-6 in the final period. As for the individual scoring, unofficially for Bishop Garrigan, Graceland Eastman had 20 to lead the way, having Bartolo in double figures of 13, Sasha Allish of 9, and Zoe Montag and Abby Capacious with 7 apiece. For North Iowa, Miriam Binken had 18 to lead the way. It was Ashlyn Beekler scoring 7. Bella Langfold had 7 as well. You had Emma Eichenberger of 6, Becca Hoffman of 5, and Aisha Job scoring 4 in tonight's game. I'm Tyler Lance. My partner is Beanie Bodie. Beanie, what an incredible matchup tonight. North Iowa got down 21-9 early in the second quarter, and at that point, a previous Bison team might have rolled over and gotten blown out by the Bears. This team did not. They rallied back, took the lead a couple of times, including in the second half against Bishop Garrigan, but ultimately, the back-to-back state champions showed their mettle. They hit some key three-pointers late, they made the defensive stops, and they ultimately win today's game.
For sure. I think resilient is the word of the night, both for the Bears sticking with it, but especially for the Bison program. Played the Bears 3 times this year, got better every time. Boy, and they had no quit in them tonight, fight until the very last second. Very impressed with this North Iowa Bison team. It's going to be a team that's going to build in the future. Very good game tonight, Tyler. We continue to be having a great strip of great games here as broadcasters, dating back for 2 weeks. Boy, folks, you got to listen to the games. They're all good these days. Gone are the days of the blowouts, and these have been some fun contests and some very spirited matchups. All in all, a great game, well officiated, well coached, and a fun night here in the Garrigan Gym on just a Tuesday with more basketball to come later this week.
100%. In fact, Bishop Garrigan's boys won a close game last night against the top of Iowa West opponents. That was West Hancock, as the Garrigan boys will play on Thursday night against Norfolk Kensett. This Garrigan girls team, they'll play on Friday night. That'll be against Newman Catholic or St. Ansgar, trying to track down a score for that one, but haven't been able to find it yet. So we'll keep you posted on that. But, you know, Garrigan gets a big test tonight. You know, I'll ask you the same question, Beanie, I asked after the West Hancock game. We thought the three-pointers were back on track after Garrigan made 11 against North Iowa in the final regular season game. Tonight, three-point numbers might look a little better than they felt just because Garrigan hit their threes late, but does it concern you that the three-pointers all of a sudden went cold again for Bishop Garrigan?
Well, it didn't until you pointed it out, Tyler, but now that you mention it, that is a bit of a concern. It's not so much that they're missing three-pointers, because the three-point shot is a low-percentage shot, and a good percentage is anything around 30% in high school girls basketball. And Bears have always shot well above that. And it's not the fact that they're not making them, Tyler. It's the fact that they're missing them badly. Some of the ones that are missing are way off the mark. It's not just bouncing around the rim and popping out. But as you said, throughout the game, they kept getting closer and closer, and then pretty soon they're draining them. Yeah, this is a scary team when the shooters get hot. But when they're not, then you got to really earn those points. And that's what Garrigan does well. They make adjustments. They go inside. They run their set plays, get some good looks at the basket. And I don't think they really had to do many set plays tonight, so they got those still up their sleeve, because now it becomes the tournament kind of becomes a game of what are you going to show these other teams on film? What kind of changes are you going to do? Tonight, the Bears, they really switched up their defense. They put Capacious on Miriam Binken, and she did a great job of shutting down her scoring when she was really hot, but then Capacious got fouled, so then you got to make another adjustment. So it's really fun to watch these games and see the adjustments that the teams are making down throughout the game. But the Bears, great teamwork. They really work well, find the hot hand, and a very unselfish play.
And one other thing to point out from this game as well, Graceland Eastman led the way of 20 points. That was a hard-working 20 points tonight. There's some nights where it kind of looks like a breeze, where the entry pass is so clean, and Eastman catches it cleanly and has a perfect angle to the glass. That was not the night tonight. North Iowa was contesting everything inside. There were a lot of non-clean catches for Eastman, where she had to pick it up off the ground and score anyways, or try to fight through contact and score, or was getting fronted by Binken and scored. So it was a really hard-working night inside for Eastman, and a lot of that passing between Capacious and Eastman really helped get the Golden Bears on track.
Yeah, I've said it a million times that Eastman doesn't look like a freshman, but one of the things that make her more mature as a player is her vision and her ability to work with teammates. She's not a one-dimensional tall person playing basketball. She can do a lot of things for a team, including work well with teammates. Well, the North Iowa Bison have come out of their locker room, and this is kind of nice to see. Their crowd sticks around, gives them a round of applause. They know that this team gave a defending state championship all they could handle tonight, and a well-deserved round of applause for the crowd that stuck around just to let the girls know how much they appreciate them and their effort as they come out of the locker room. That's a really nice thing to see here in the Garrigan gym. And, Tyler, a lot of people ask me when I'm out and about, why does Garrigan always get to play at home? Well, you know, they set the locations based on how you do during the regular season and how the tournament is seeded. It didn't used to always be like that. That's why it creates some confusion. It used to be just on who has a good gym that can fit a lot of fans in it, and then you get to host the tournament games. But now everyone's got a nice gym, and it's based on your seeding and based on the regular season play. So Garrigan very fortunate to get a play at home in the next round as well, both boys and girls. After that, though, I believe it hits the road.
Exactly. It'll be a neutral site after the next games if Garrigan should get past them. But they'll have one more game at home, both for the boys and girls, coming up Thursday and Friday of this week. Both of those games can be heard here at Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Elgorda Radio YouTube channel. That'll be all for tonight's broadcast. For my partner, Beanie Bodie, I'm Tyler Lance, signing off. This has been a sports production of Hometown Radio KLGA. Once again, the final.